Hit a backflip and then dipped off the set. Your girl having sex. She looking at me like, Lowe's, what we doing next? We might play the box. Yeah, I got one from my ex. That's the Xbox. I picked the door lock. Nigga so hot, I take a shot of the motherfucking gin. Again, I'm gonna win. Putting dick all in a friend. Now, once again, when I come with some old, kick in the front door and turn on the stereo. Hey, I meant to say turn the radio on, but you ain't gonna even be on that bitch. A tattoo on your arm of your mom. I mean you no harm. If I'ma walk up and I'm coming with some Parmesan, I might order pizza. I might get two. The more you buy, it's cheaper.
That's called a special.
I got the coupon.
Yeah.
They got to honor that shit.
It's called the Tuesday Night Special.
Yeah. Yeah.
If a rapper's a Herbie Kirby, I left him on the journey. With hospitals, devils advocate, excellent attorney. Love craft country, I get naked on the journey. My balls deep, I'm pulling out my dick Gregory. Chainsaw massacre, melanin face, leathery, feathery hat, throwback, starter jacket's a down coat. John on the beat, so everything got a sound dope. Four eyes, that second half, I've been around smoke. King of pop, Pro Bowl shot, and then the crown broke. Ground folk suffer that PTS from slavery. Pimpin', I'm a ball wherever Ohio players be. Prayers to the church on the moon, I mastered it. Lyrical disaster, these niggas is blasphemous.
Woo! Okay, man.
Goddamn.
Instagram, man, nigga.
Okay.
Right now, Instagram, man.
Whoa, we're getting
man,
getting
you don't know fool. Nigga, he the coldest, boldest nigga that I done never seen. Every time I see him, we on a different scene. Hey, you know what I mean?
Why that boy spit?
We from the bay with them yacht of our beans inside of our scene. Bitch, you the sight of our scene. I'm type of nigga be wearing jogging pants and flipping jeans. And keep it clean and pull up just with your knee. And then hit it all in the spleen with the pain. You ain't seen what I done seen.
All in the spleen with the pain.
All in the spleen with the pain. Had an old chick named Janine. She kept her house clean.
She made a whole lot of collard greens.
Come on.
That shit had a lot of steam.
Come on.
She took the pot off the top.
Uh-huh.
Top off the pot.
Come on.
Fiona's name Scott.
Come on.
I'm on live right now on my IG. I'm in ATL doing the B.I.G. Putting out that smoke is in my face. I'm getting contact.
Yes, you will.
I'm not gonna walk by.
Yeah, I'm telling you, man, cause I be higher than a bitch.
Not
in the kitchen
really,
trying
focused,
to fry
no
chicken wing and shit.
Come on,
with the
Lord.
Bread and the hot sauce and keep it real. Just some nigga shit, cause that's how I really feel.
Hey.
You got a headache, take an Advil. And then take a nap and then really chill.
Chill.
I mean, I stay higher than the light bill. Nigga, do you even know what that is? That's the biggest bill most niggas got. Shit ain't really been the same since Pac got shot. Y'all be letting niggas get away with everything. Seen a nigga grab a nigga purse and touch a ding-a-ling. Oh!
Touch a ding-a-ling?
Jeez. That's
a flavor.
What?
Goodness.
I'm gonna go here freestyle. Y'all see where I'm at? I'm with Lil Bro.
This just trap shit, man. That's how it's supposed to be. We got all types of things going on in here today. You know what I'm saying? We got a lot to celebrate. Just found out. 85 South Show was rated the blackest show on earth. This the blackest show on earth.
Shit.
This show black as hell.
ATL, I'm here. Comedy Theater.
We in here. You know what? Today we got some very special guests in the trap with us today. I don't know if you have been in jail for the last 12, 15 summers, or if your TV just been broke, or you just don't watch shit where people are doing great things. But this nigga right here has been part of a lot of great black things, from the movies to to the television shows, to the impressions, to Soul Train, to Wildin' Out, to shit, what, Meet the Blacks? Meet the Blacks again.
Actually, I wasn't in that.
Oh, well, they should have put you in. Shit, Wildin' Out alumni. Nigga was on the first episode before it was an episode. Ladies and gentlemen, Affion Crockett is in here with us. The list goes on and on. The list goes on and on. Big fan. My man Brandon Lewis is in here with us today. Don't act like you don't see him all over the internet talking shit and things of that nature.
Roasting niggas.
And then we got America's favorite hood chick.
Don't call me white girl.
Mona is in here with us too. You see how I put this shit together? This is like such a well-rounded cast. Affion, first of all, this is your first time in the trap. So welcome to the trap.
Thank you, man. Thank you for having
Marvin
me,
Gaye is in attendance with us today. Also, my forever co-host.
I don't even need to turn around and look. Marvin is always in my soul, so I appreciate his presence.
Yeah.
Right here.
Man, what's been going on? How you living, G?
I'm living good, man. Pandemic been good to me. I'm healthy.
Hell yeah.
COVID-free as a motherfucker.
Been seeing you popping in on all these interviews, giving the backstories. Man, I was up late watching Soul Train clips and shit like that. You're like, what's the shit you did, like with TV One or some shit?
Yeah.
You know how that shit pop up on your YouTube? I was like, nigga, what ain't you talking about? Didn't this nigga come out doing this shit? I was like, yeah. Bruh.
Spaghetti body.
Hey, and your Apollo clip done went viral on Facebook again this week.
Heavy.
Man.
Yeah.
So you got a lot of history, bro. How did you get started with the entertainment?
Dancing, really. Dancing has always been my thing, and dancing is what put me on stage first.
Yeah.
So by the time Def Comedy Jam came around, I saw hip-hop and comedy merge, and the hip-hop, I was already a part of that. The only missing link was comedy for me.
Yeah.
So when I saw comedians like Kool Bubba Ice going there, and at the time, I wasn't a comedian. I didn't even know I could do comedy. It wasn't an aspiration.
Right.
But when I saw him go on and do all impressions, I was like, oh shit, I've been doing voices since I was a kid. I'm a dancer. I know how to work a stage. So I just started trying shit, and that's how I got in.
Man, you've been killing it with the impressions. What's the number on it now? Like, how many impressions would you say you do?
I have no idea. Because some people I forget I do, and I just don't do them in a while. And then somebody new will come up. Like, I just randomly did DJ Cassidy on the Versus reenactment. But it's not like I had a spot-on impression of him. I had the glasses, the hat, and when he was DJing for Keith and Bobby Brown Versus,
yeah,
I just came out doing wacky shit, and everybody was dying off of that shit.
That series that you and Spice Adams created, where y'all recreate the Versus joint.
The after show?
Yeah, like, how did that shit come out?
When Teddy and Babyface fucked up, when Teddy Riley had all the bad Wi-Fi, that's really where we decided to do it. We was like, man, we should spoof this shit.
They gotta let Teddy go again.
They do.
He need to do it.
No, some real shit. They gotta let Teddy go again. He got a whole other set of hits that he ain't get to use.
He a legend.
But he went twice, though, didn't he?
He gotta go again.
He gotta go three times.
It don't matter.
He got enough to where he could go again.
Yeah, he could go again.
Yeah.
For sure.
Factuals.
That Versus shit really been interesting though, bro. That Gladys Knight, who she went against?
Patty.
Oh yeah.
Miss Patty.
That was a good one. Gladys Patty. Was.
Soulja Boy Bow Wow was the funniest.
Yeah, for sure. Big Draco.
That shit was funny.
We gotta get Soulja Boy on this bitch.
He ain't been on here?
He ain't been on here.
This is prime time Soulja Boy Entertainment right here. He should be on here.
For sure.
I'm saying, bro, this is.
Somebody text that nigga. I know one of y'all niggas in here know Soulja Boy.
Don't nobody. Jack
somebody
know
him. Draco.
Get Big Draco on the line.
Big Draco. First rapper to do Eddie
My fault, yeah.
He ain't the first rapper to do the shit.
Oh, he will be after
y'all
he does.
Y'all had some heavy hitters on here. Y'all had some heavy hitters on here.
Yeah, we got y'all on here. Fuck you mean? You on here.
Thank you, my nigga.
Nigga, you was on the real Def Comedy Jam.
I actually was. That was my first comedy experience, nigga. I was in a room full of legends. I mean, that's if you know anything about your spirit, that's when you know God talking to you, saying you made the right decision. When you look to your left, you see Cedric the Entertainer. You look to your right, you see J. Anthony Brown. You see Jamie Foxx. You see Russell Simmons. You see everyone who's who. Chris Rock. Everybody was in this one room.
Yeah.
So I was like, all right, I got some work to do. I got a journey in front of me, but I feel like I made the right decision.
Mm.
It's crazy.
That Meet the Black shit taking off too.
Was the third one or second one?
I don't know.
I think they're on part two.
Part two.
Yeah, it's part two, the scary joint.
Well, you got some legendary scenes up in there. And it's like, shit hitting different, especially with social media. House. That's the one.
Yeah, yeah,
but you know I'm talking. I can't remember all this
about.
Shit.
I knew what you're talking about. The Haunted House, Marlon Wayans. Yeah. Ray.
And you know, these movies is hitting different now, because now these clips getting like all this fucking use that you never thought they would. Every time you like click on some shit, it's some motherfuckers posting comments and then clips and videos and shit.
Yeah.
Especially now, like with the I don't give a fuck.
Right. We had
Phoenix when the white boy did that shit.
He was in a restaurant.
Random as hell.
Two weeks ago.
Walked out. He was like, I don't give a fuck. He said it perfect though, like a white man. He's like, I don't give a fuck, Keisha. He just walked out.
Loud.
Loud as hell, like he was one of them.
That was real inconsiderate, cause he just left y'all with that bitch.
It just left.
Like everybody in the restaurant don't know what the fuck going on.
But he looked back. But he looked back when he shut the like when he went out the door. He looked back to make sure we heard him.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So y'all been on the road and shit.
Yeah. Shout out to this boy, man, Brandon Lewis. This nigga, cold blooded. We been on the road for what, 3-4 years now?
Yeah, I've been knowing that nigga when he wasn't shit, bro.
Man, I knew Karlous Miller when we did MTV Yo Mama.
Exactly. Nigga ain't even have a lineup.
Nothing.
That's how far we go back.
All the way back.
Far back.
When I thought Hollywood was going to be calling my fucking phone when I did that show.
I'm like,
what's taking so long?
Ain't that a bitch?
Didn't nobody give a fuck about that show.
Nobody.
Not even the people who watched it.
How many times have y'all had that job though where you was like, oh nigga, this is about to be the one?
Every time
here.
I get one.
I'm sitting
every
at it,
single
girl.
Time.
Really?
You sitting at
I'm
it?
I'm here, yeah.
Yeah, you on
this
now, Mona.
This got
I'm
to
telling
be
you. We finna get you on.
What else is left to do?
You in here with Affion and
exactly.
Shit. Somebody gonna see
light
you.
Light skin couch.
Light skin couch. I'm
That's
here
what
for
y'all
it.
Doing. Just, trying
here.
To take
I'm
over.
Here for it.
Yeah, we're not
me and
scared.
The melanin deficient couch.
Nah,
we here though, man. I'm glad to be here. I'm proud of what y'all doing. I remember when me and you had a convo.
Yeah.
You was trying to figure some shit out, and then here you are.
I'm still trying to figure some shit out. We're going to have another one, man.
Let me know.
I'm telling you, shit is getting so weird right now. I'm having
Come on, man.
A fucking dilemma.
Well, I'm always an ear. You know what I'm saying?
The whole world got
I don't know everything.
Hey, man, you know about
but
this
I know
shit,
enough.
Hey, man.
I know enough to help little bro.
Hey, man. Bro, how you link up with Nick, bro? Get
shit,
on wildin'
the
out
same as
start,
most of y'all
like
did.
You was one of those ones you was had a lot to do with the start of that shit though.
Yeah,
right
he
with
said
it.
That he built the show for niggas like me, but I still had to audition 5 times for that shit.
That's the type of shit he do.
I wish I could say yeah, nah, he just called and it was a wrap, but it almost wasn't. Shout out to DJ D-Rec, my boy.
He fought for you.
That's my guy. Yeah, Derek was inside the room. In the office, and he was like, yo, why y'all not just booking this nigga Affion? Since day one, he was the one that was like advocating. But again, Nick came to me, I saw him in Vegas one time. He's like, nah, I got a show for you, man. I'm gonna call you next week. MTV, you got, you know. He did say, you're gonna have to audition, but it's built for you. We ready for you. But I was like, why am I auditioning? And then half the people in the room wasn't like incredible. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Like, I'm freestyling. The same way you were just going.
I know exactly what you're saying.
You know exactly what I'm saying.
Yeah. Yeah.
So, Los, I'm in the audition room, and I just black out. I'm freestyling. I'm talking about the producers in the back of the room. I talked about Nile. I ain't even know Nile at the time. I was talking about his shorts. I was roasting niggas and just pointing at them. And they was all like, oh, my God. Oh, my God. 3 more auditions later, nigga.
Damn.
Like, I thought I just did my 8 Mile Eminem shit. Like, just really killed it. And nah, but you know, what I learned is this. Everything is a journey, and you gotta remove all bitterness from the journey. And here's why I say that. Because you well know that there's some fuck shit that can go on the business side of things. And you have to remember that it's business. We always think it's personal shit, but when it's business, you have to literally look at yourself as this fucking bottle. It's a product, and people are making a decision based on that product. whether they want that product on their shelf or not. And so I used to be sensitive about a lot of shit. I used to be personal about a lot of shit. And then I finally was like, oh, okay, you don't, you just making a decision about my product. And you think that removing the product from the shelf is gonna discontinue sales, but you don't understand that I manufacture this product and I know other distributors that's going.
And I don't need my shit in everybody's store.
I don't need my shit in that particular store. So that's my outlook on this whole thing.
Hey, bro, you know all the tour dates are out now.
All the tour dates are out?
No, we don't need that anymore.
Yeah, all of them out?
Yeah.
So, all of them up?
All of them up.
So they online, 85southshow.com.
Yes.
Where all the tour dates is, because I'm tired of motherfuckers asking me, where can I get the tickets? Bitch, they not in my pocket.
Right, all the way.
85 South Show.
These are the shows that we going to do as long as the world stay open. So get your tickets. So if the world open, then we gonna come. And if it closed, you already got your tickets, so we gonna come when it open back up.
Yeah, we just gonna come to your house.
All the way.
Tell them where we at.
Hey, look, the 7th of August, we in Greenville, South Carolina at the Bond Secure Wellness Center.
Uh-huh, talk your shit.
Bond Secure.
Bond Secure.
August 14th, mm-hmm. We'll be in Fayetteville, North Carolina at the Crown Coliseum.
Yeah. Then get what?
What?
Get where we going?
Where?
To the bottom of the mountain.
All right, wait, what?
September 11th, show live Jacksonville, Florida at the Bond Star.
The Bond Star. Do you know where we going?
Where we going?
To the west side.
No!
Where? The top of the west side.
West Coast, North, man!
All the way. Seattle, Washington. Put them on the glass. Home of Baby Got Back. Sir Mix-a-Lot.
Showing
them. Seattle, Washington. We at the WAMU Theater.
That's October 1st. Showing them. Then October 2nd. We in Sacramento.
We're going back to the sack time.
And then that's at the Memorial Auditorium.
Yeah. Then 10/29, we back at the bottom of the map, like DC said.
Tallahassee.
You know what I mean?
September 29th.
We at the Donald Tucker Civic Center.
That's October 29th.
That's October 29th. Yeah.
October.
Then November, we got some days then too.
Where we going?
November 5th. North Charleston, South Carolina.
Showed it.
North Charleston, Coliseum.
That where we at?
Then we got it.
Then right after that, we don't get no break. Where we going? Greensboro, North Carolina.
At the Greensboro Coliseum. Y'all better sell that out.
They couldn't come up with a name.
Every time y'all see me in Greensboro, y'all be like, when y'all coming to Greensboro? When y'all coming to Greensboro? Chico, y'all don't fuck with us? Y'all don't fuck with Greensboro? Yes. 11/6, I expect to see all y'all to be coming up to me in Four Seasons Mall at the show. So please, 11/6, Greensboro Coliseum.
Bro.
What?
No more. What the fuck are we doing?
Bro, ain't no, they Atlanta. They gonna keep asking us about Atlanta. Don't even tell them.
Yeah.
Just go to 85southshow.com.
Yeah, don't tell them.
Get some
don't tell
information
them.
On them tour dates.
We just moonwalking on you hoes.
Yeah, you did.
I don't know who gonna pick that shit up.
Right, this it for now.
This it for now. But if y'all buy
throw
these
the
tickets,
let them know you mean business.
If y'all buy these tickets, we
just in case y'all need some more papers,
throw
them.
Hey, you want some more? Yeah, throw them down here.
Hey, buy them tickets, man. We not playing with y'all. We mean business.
We'll do it live.
Okay,
we'll do it live.
But shout out to Nick. Like, don't. The audition shit was, it was, you know, tedious, whatever. But he gave me the platform to be where I am today. Like, I've said that publicly. I've said that in his face. I said it on Wild and Out. I've said it. I've never shied away from giving Nick his flowers.
Yeah.
And I never will. I never stop doing it.
It ain't never got shit to do with him.
Right. But again, back to what I was saying, it's never a personal thing.
Yeah, that's the part
and
about it.
It's like, there's other decision makers involved.
That's the part about it, where you just be like, who said that? And they be like,
because also real
I get right back
shit.
With you. Can't nobody, bro, that's the shit. That's my frustration is don't nobody know shit.
On some real nigga shit, you be wanting to know.
Came, yeah, they can't tell you where this shit came from. You're like, well, they said, who said that?
Point them out to me.
Right.
I want to talk to that person that said that. And they don't do that in Hollywood.
Hell
they pass
no,
the buck.
Hell no.
No, no, no. Well, Karlous, you need to calm down.
I don't.
You need to calm down. Be, just be, look, it's all going to be good.
It's not, though.
Who the fuck said it, though?
But they won't. Like, they won't even tell me who fired me. They still there. I know. I'll probably see them every day.
Damn, that's crazy.
It's part of the game.
Yeah. The same motherfuckers who don't want you there, I got to be with you every day. Make them sick.
What was the first?
That's why when I be having fun, I be having extra fun. I don't give a fuck what it is. It's like, I don't give a fuck if I'm laughing, nigga. I'm extra laughing. I'm extra as fuck. Whatever it is, nigga, just you gonna see me in abundance.
Was people shocked when you came back?
Yeah, niggas was crying. Not the motherfucking cast, nigga, just worked there. That's how I knew. When I came and all them nigga, the cameramen, all, you know the motherfucking cameramen, all
yeah,
up.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like, loose, my man! They was crying and shit. I was like, nigga, it was white people crying.
Damn.
Just their favorite nigga.
That's hard.
That's, hey, man, fuck
it. But you flipped it, man. You flipped the opportunity in the best way possible. You, Chico, DC, y'all really have built an empire off of what that platform provided for you. Now, I don't know the ins and outs of your journey, of the story, but again, I'm just talking about from what I'm seeing from the outside looking in.
My journey, you listen to Rick Ross?
Yeah.
Rick Ross got the coldest line about all, that'll sum all this shit up.
Oh.
I would always tell my niggas, but ain't nobody listen. That's how you sum it up, Mona.
Nas got a line. He say, I got no game. It's just some bitches understand my story. Let it sit.
You don't listen to nobody? I thought this nigga had one, too. Nothing.
I'm like, damn, that was deep.
He got no game.
I'm still thinking about when I didn't get the $1,000 on MTV. When they said cut, I thought this money was mine.
You didn't get the money?
What happened?
They was like, I had it in my hand. I was like, I got my $1,000. And they was like, and cut. They tried to grab it. I'm like, this mine. They like, no, we're going to give a check. I'm like, no, it's over. He like, no. We was tugging for that shit for like a solid minute. And then they was like, it took like 180 days.
Yeah.
Damn. I'm like, why it take so long for $1,000?
I don't know. That show was some bullshit.
They good for holding up money in the
pipeline. That's Hollywood, though. That's when I learned the business side.
Yeah, you asked what job I get. Every job. Every one of them. Yeah, I don't give a fuck what it is, nigga. I thought all of them was the one. But now that I see, you got to have a whole bunch of little ones and then get a big one.
But you never can tell which is going to be that one. You think something's going to be little and then that shit blow the fuck up. You never know.
I'm talking about the one that the people who making the movie gonna believe gonna be the big one. Mm-hmm. Where it's like some nice money up front. It ain't like some comeback money where you can get booked off some appearances and shit. I'm talking about.
Right.
Like, fuck what the people think is the one that's the one for me. That big ass check. I mean, like, Los, that movie was terrible. I'm like, nigga, I made $17 million.
Exactly.
That's the one.
Sheesh. Right.
Yeah. You know that movie, like, that's some bullshit, but it's like you get a good deal on the back end, and then,
oh, yeah,
like you
yeah,
said,
yeah,
the shit that nobody expected it to be the shit. And
oh, yeah.
Yeah. Next thing you know, you in the Notebook too, crying and dancing with some white people. You the most well-known nigga ever. Yeah, that's it.
That back end be lovely, though.
Yeah.
I love that. Yeah, don't pay me shit up front. Give me back end points.
I ain't sticking around long. I'm gonna hit me a lick and get the fuck on. I'm not even gonna give the industry a chance to not like me. I'm leaving.
What's that number on that lick?
Nigga, about 20 million. I'm going to Mississippi. You'll never hear from me again.
You're gonna get a lot of
you fucking right. I'm desperate. Should pay the taxes, I'm out.
I don't believe you, though.
I'm telling you, I'm not staying.
You may not stay in the traditional industry, but I see you being on some Chappelle shit. You gonna get a shitload of land in Mississippi.
You right.
And you gonna have a gang of shows. You gonna bring niggas out there.
I am.
And do it on your terms.
They gotta come see me.
$20 million, you own Mississippi, nigga.
Nah.
Half, okay.
Do you understand everything? That ain't even a lot of money. It's an old white lady in Mississippi with $20 million.
I can give you that.
Cause she collects shopping bags.
Nah, she just been rich her whole life.
She went,
whole
she
family
collect
rich.
Old bottles for 15 whole cents. Family. $20 million.
I'm going to get me a couple of M's out this game, then I'm dipping. I'm going to just move to my land and get fat. Get me a dog and a lady with some nice titties. I'm out of here. Fuck this shit.
I'm stealing this table when I leave.
Nah, I'm going to get you one if you want one.
Yeah,
I know. I had a nigga send it to you.
I'm going
to
need that.
This shit dope, man.
Oh yeah, this is a black owned joint, right? The black.
Yeah.
What type of titties though? Dolly Parton titties or?
Nah.
That's too big.
Dolly Parton has some.
It's the wrong color.
No, titties. Yeah, exactly. I'm talking about. I don't know. I think the ones that last the longest be like them church lady titties.
We know you melanated.
Yeah.
Who is black? Who is a black woman with famous titties?
There's a lot of black women with famous titties.
Pam Grier.
Pam Grier.
Foxy Brown.
Pam Grier titties, known for titties. Yeah. I thought Pam Grier more for face. I ain't never thought.
No, it's Foxy Brown is the body.
Nigga,
sure.
Go watch.
No, I'm saying Dolly Parton, y'all know that's titties.
You can run out the Pam Grier.
Go watch Coffee
now.
Tonight.
You are you trying to say who the most famous black titties?
Pam Grier, Jack Boggs, and Jackie Brown. She was the most famous.
Who is the most famous black woman known for titties? Dolly Parton.
Right now?
Right now. And no, period. I never know. Aretha Franklin known for her titties.
Yes, she is.
Yes, she is.
She known for titties.
When you think Aretha Franklin, you think titties.
No one
when I say
Dolly
Parton, he be like,
I'm thinking.
Titties.
I'm thinking. No Jill Scott got the title
Jill,
right now.
And then we saw them.
I think Jill got the title right now.
She got nice titties too. Shout out to Jill.
Queen Latifah had them for a minute.
No one has been labeled. No black woman has been labeled as the titty woman.
Because they told us to stop. They said we was over sexualizing the women, so then we couldn't
so
really.
So Dolly has the crown, for the titty crown.
Right.
As soon as you say Dolly Parton, titties.
That's too big. But Foxy Brown.
Exactly. See, look, you just said too big. Mm. Titties. Mm. Foxy Brown, you saying, oh, she fine. That's just an ideal woman, shape and everything. Jill Scott. I can give you that one. I can give you that one a little bit, but still, Jill Scott known for her face.
I'm still trying to
and
think.
Her voice.
Did we overlook somebody?
Queen Latifah got to be living single. Queen Latifah.
Nah, I think Queen Latifah titties. I think when she played Bessie, she
yeah, she pulled them
sweaty.
Out, and then it's like, mm-hmm.
No, nobody
oh,
like
damn,
those
I titties.
I never disrespect them titties, but
I feel like they nicer titties. It just wasn't a good scene for the titties.
I don't think that. I think those that was as good as they was gonna get.
That's all.
I don't even know.
Your titties on a hot summer day. You don't want to take a picture then. You stand in front of the fan. You trying to cool your tits off. You might lift them.
Not saying nothing was wrong with them titties, but those are not the ones that they led me to believe they was gonna be. I was deceived.
She had nice nipples.
They was cool, but you know.
Those are real titties.
Those
titties don't sit up.
And I'm not mad at that. I don't give a fuck if your titties look like torpedoes. Just show up with what I expected you to have. Like, what you led me up to believe, those titties that she had in those movies, those weren't Khadijah's titties.
No.
Those was the other ones. You
those
brought it
set
up.
Set it off titties.
Yeah. What are you from?
Philadelphia.
I heard it.
You heard the accent?
You those don't know, mama. She just be saying a lot of wild shit, man. That's why I love her. She just be saying any fucking thing. She got the world saying, the mad thing, mad thing.
The what?
You pussy pap ready.
The what?
You know how you gonna have a pap smear? He didn't tell you.
He don't.
Well, I've never been, but.
So now the cat's a bit furry.
Okay.
Maybe a little sweaty. You weren't ready for the pap.
You ain't showered before.
Right, so because I would have had a pap shower.
You had a full day in the humid Philly streets and you wouldn't get your pap after that?
I came here for a regular doctor's visit and you talking about pap.
Right. So you gotta open up that.
But I'm still gonna let you do the pack because you ain't ready to play me like this pussy stain.
Right.
Because it don't.
Goodness gracious.
It's tough.
I don't know. After a long day, I don't give a fuck how. Yeah, it smell like.
It's a little twang too.
It smell like an underarm pit after a gym workout.
Whoa.
No. Now, I drink water and shit.
Yeah, but after a long, sweaty, humid day, I know Philly. Philly humid as fuck.
A lot of walking.
It's a lot of that. It's a lot of incubation that's going on in your pussy meat. And so
it's a lot of black streets.
You can drink all the water you want, but that sweat and that salt is gonna create motherfucking spam in your pants.
I like to call it twang.
Wow. You like to call it what?
Call it what you want, but it's gonna knock a nigga out.
Taste tort got a twang.
Tomato, tomato.
Niggas got it rough out here.
Sun-dried tomato, nigga. That shit's tart.
When you say tart, when a woman says tart, you gotta be like, fuck it, let's go.
Exactly, you with it.
But you gotta think, it's a little hesitation. But then it's like, fuck it, come on.
You're not turning
that. It is what it is.
It is what it is.
Well, tart is after you leave the club. Like, y'all been dancing on each other all night. You gonna pop it.
For sure.
But as a man, we don't wanna hear that.
Yeah.
That's why, like, when you say tart, you be like, chill.
You be fucking, you keep your nose up. You
like, when you say tart, you like, come on, man.
You still popping after she says tart.
Exactly, but I'm gonna think about tart. It. Like, it's gonna be a quick thing. It's gonna be like, fuck it, let's go.
You could have did without the tart comment.
Yeah, exactly.
To sum it up.
But you a real street nigga, she smoking the blood.
Exactly.
He know. He danced, so he been in the club dancing with a chick.
I know. We've been sweating, and then we leave and we get it popping. But if I know that her pussy don't stink on a regular basis, but you right.
That nigga I've been dancing with. Damn, bro, you do know.
I done danced with a lot of women. And,
you ever dance and get a whiff of ass?
That pussy sweats. Yeah. Yeah.
Dancing niggas got it easy, bro. When do y'all come up with routines? Because dancing niggas just show up with a dance. Like, nigga, when y'all practice this shit?
Yeah, niggas gather in the garage, in the fucking the hallway. The
so niggas be having secret meetings and be like, all right, nigga, if I do this, you do this.
Then I'm gonna pass it to you.
And then after that move, we like, oh, you went there? All right, nigga, well, I'm about to go here.
Can you break dance?
I do it all.
Spin on your head?
All of that shit. I mean, not anymore.
But you do realize that we live in a time where you can make money just going to people's wedding and dancing.
Facts.
Yeah. You know how many fans you got? Like, eighth, bro. Like, the reception is gonna be crazy. How much to get you to come and fucking battle me? In front of my wife.
In front of my wife.
Dude, I got 15 grand. Her pop's fucking loaded, man. Just come to the wedding, fucking battle me. That's all I want. And then y'all come up with a routine and shit.
Oh, that's not a routine. You just give me that 15 and I'll come smoke you real quick.
You take this shit serious?
You be serious? You not gonna let the nigga win on his wedding day?
You ain't gonna let nigga win on his special day?
Nigga, you have no idea how competitive dancing niggas are for real, if that's the case.
It's too competitive, nigga. I can't let you. You gotta beat me for real. In your tux.
Pop lock me, nigga.
You gotta beat me, nigga. You paying me 15, I'ma take the 15. I'ma eat your food, and then I'ma beat you in the battle.
So what's the one song, like, dance? What's your song that you can't resist? Like, I gotta dance.
Just Begun, Jimmy Castor.
Who?
Who?
Play it, DJ.
Who the fuck is that?
Yeah, I don't know.
What's your song again?
Somebody played Jimmy Castor, Just Begun. And you'll understand what I'm talking about. Y'all young motherfuckers in here, y'all don't know shit.
Let's get this young.
When did you get him out in the 50s?
But look, here's the thing though.
If I said some mystical shit, y'all would be like, oh nigga, yeah.
Chuck Berry.
But that sound like
Jimmy Castor, long time coming.
Swizz.
They played that on the commercial.
Play that shit and see what happens.
Play the song, let's get this nigga.
Half the niggas that don't know it gonna get up and be like, oh shit. Turn that shit up.
Oh, there's some breakdancing
shit. Breakdancing
shit.
Turn it up.
Oh, he's letting know it.
Who this fucking table? And that's some cardboard and shit. I stand in the back like this. This is some old shit. This is when rap first came out.
Gonna make you move.
This nigga telling his age.
All right, that's enough. We can't play the old shit. We're gonna get flagged. Jimmy Castor sued the shit out of us.
I want every fucking thing.
Hey, I'm Karlous Miller. Have you ever got home after a long day at work and you forgot to grab some food? DoorDash can help with that and you don't have to leave the house again. Ordering is easy. Open the DoorDash app, choose what you want from where you want, and your items will be left safely outside your door with the contactless delivery drop-off setting. With over 300,000 partners in the US, Puerto Rico, Canada, and Australia, you can support your neighborhood go-tos or choose from your favorite national restaurants like Popeyes, Chipotle, Cheesecake Factory. DoorDash connects you with restaurants that you love right now and right to your door. Come on now. For a limited time, our listeners can get 25% off and zero delivery fees on the first order of $15 or more when you download the DoorDash app and enter the code 85South 2021. That's 25% off up to a $10 value and zero delivery fees on your first order when you download the DoorDash app in the App Store and enter the code 85South 2021. Don't forget, that's code 85South 2021 for 25% off your first order with DoorDash. Subject to change, terms apply. This episode is sponsored by Blue Chew. Hey, what's up? It's your man, Karlous Miller. Look, everybody keeps asking me, does Blue Chew really work? Does Blue Chew really work? Yes, go to the website right now. They don't believe that I believe that you're gonna go. So go to the website, that's bluechew.com/85South. Use the promo code 85South, and they will send you your first shipment of Blue Chew for free. Just pay $5 shipping. That's right. If you use the promo code 85South, Blue Chew will send you your first month of Blue Chew for free. So hit the website, use the code, and see if it works for yourself. Because it does. Made right here in the USA. And they're gonna ship it straight to the crib. No waiting in line. They got medical professionals ready to talk to you right now. Hit the website, use the code, and live your life. I'm telling you, BlueChew.com. Go get you some. You can make love to your lady for a long time if you want to. That's what I be doing. I be using it. You don't got none. Hey, I'm Karlous Miller. Is there something interfering with your happiness or preventing you from achieving your goals? BetterHelp will assess your needs and match you with your own licensed professional therapist. The service is available for clients worldwide, and you can start communicating in under 48 hours. It's not a crisis line. It's not a self-help line. It's professional counseling done securely online. You'll get timely and thoughtful responses, plus you can schedule weekly video or phone sessions, so you won't ever have to sit in an uncomfortable waiting room as with traditional therapy. BetterHelp is committed to facilitating great therapeutic matches, so they make it easy and free to change counselors if needed. This podcast is sponsored by BetterHelp, and 85 South Show listeners get 10% off their first month at betterhelp.com/85South. Visit betterhelp.com/85South. That's Better, H-E-L-P, and join the over 1 million people who have taken charge of their mental health with the help of experienced professionals.
Damn. Nobody told him to make my song a rap song anyway.
What is that, jazz? That's jazz, right?
He a nigga. Mm-hmm. It's a funk song.
That's funk.
Yeah.
That sound like a B-roll of a dope movie when they going through packing shit.
Oh, it's been in all of them.
Sound like beat shootout.
It's been in all of them. That song, legendary.
Tell me about a legendary dance battle you had. Man. We don't get to hear a lot of these stories.
There was one in Raleigh, North Carolina.
Okay.
Well, me and my boys almost died because of the battle.
What the fuck?
Yeah.
That was too dark, man. Hold on, wait a minute.
No, you gotta hear why it's legendary, though.
Okay, bet.
So we three niggas, the Apollo footage, the same three niggas, me and the twins, we went to Raleigh, because at the time, that's when you knew who was who in different cities and shit.
Yeah.
So you knew who the crews were, or you knew who had dope dancers. So we was out in Raleigh hanging out with some chicks, and they was like, yo, let's go to the club. We was like, yeah, we need to go to the club. We want to see who y'all dancers are. So anyway, we in the club, and, you know, the club looked a lot like this, but times 100. It's niggas, is, you know, a little more gold and shit, chains and shit. It was a lot of that. And so we in the club all night. We with these chicks, but we would break off and we start ciphering. We dancing, we doing all our flips, we doing all our shit.
And you imagine so, you in the club, it's three niggas on three different sides of the club.
Doing flips. A lot of competition.
With MC Hammer shoes with silver tips on.
Nah, we ain't had this. We couldn't dance in that. They're too slippery.
Silver tips.
I couldn't do that shit.
So you killing them, you doing backflips and some motion.
You know, when you start dancing, everybody form a big ass circle. So we in they town, we in they club, we ain't never been here before. So we was already taking a risk doing that shit. And so literally, the song, the same song we danced to on Apollo, is called Hot Music by Soho. The DJ put this shit on. This is like 2 hours into the club night. DJ put this shit on. We literally see the whole club follow these other three niggas in a wave. They came right over to us. So they've been plotting that shit all night. So the nigga dancing and shit. One nigga do a quick flip and land in a split. And the twins are self-taught gymnasts. They nigga gymnasts. They used to flip off their mama house.
Self-taught.
So these niggas looked at each other and laughed. And one of the twins start flipping in one place. Like he just kept rotating. Handspring. Bop, 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 bop. 11 times.
Bop, bop, bop.
In front of this nigga. We start beating these niggas so bad, they were sitting Indian style in the circle, watching us, with a bunch of thug niggas behind them. The thug niggas was mad that they niggas was sitting down. They was like, man, get out there, get these niggas. So one of them, the twin is out there dancing. One of them starts to swing on the twin. The twin, on some Mayweather shit, he ain't even see the nigga. He's bobbing him and
you
dancing.
Mean to tell me this nigga outdanced a nigga punching at him? You imagine trying to hit a nigga out of anger and this nigga, he don't even know he fighting. Man, what the fuck is going on?
He missed him every swing.
Talent.
So I see the shit, and I'm like, oh, fuck, it's about to go down. We finna die. So out of nowhere, I Bruce Leroy kicked this nigga in the back.
The twin?
No, I kicked the nigga that's trying to punch him.
Oh, damn.
Because to me, I'm like, oh, we in a fight now. Because he's swinging. Somebody going to swing on me next. Well, I kicked this nigga in the back, and he went like this. Ah! And I see all the niggas in the back taking their shit off. And then security came, and, you know, we lived. But it almost, it could have got dicey.
Nigga, out of all the stories I ever heard about some niggas dancing, I ain't never heard death being involved.
Did the twin ever stop pop locking, or did he pop?
That nigga was still backflipping while this whole shit was going on.
Did he, like, moonwalk out that joint?
Nah. We had to get security. And I backed up against the wall, because I was like, if it's going to come at me,
that's
I don't want nobody
spot
to.
When you get
yeah,
jumped.
Yeah, I was like,
fuck
it. Let me
that's the coldest part about the internet. Somebody in the comments going to be like, I was at the club that night.
Yeah.
So I remember that shit. Rematch, nigga.
Nigga going to have a club name and everything. That was Club Ecstasy.
Round two.
That bitch used to be raw. Any nigga came in there dancing real good, got their ass whooped.
No, it really went down like that. It sounds far-fetched, but we lived through that shit. And that they was known for killing niggas up there.
I believe it.
Live the pop lock another day. It's a good one.
Money is good.
Live the pop lock another day.
That was lit.
North Carolina niggas.
What part of North
different.
Carolina that was?
Raleigh.
Raleigh, North Carolina.
They did a show in Raleigh. They rowdy.
Don't you?
They rowdy.
Dance
yeah, they real niggas. They real niggas.
Yeah, they definitely real.
They
niggas.
They always be real.
I fucks with North Carolina in the real. It's some good ass food up there. It's that barbecue shit that I like. They got good barbecue at the airport in there. That's the best shit in there.
They do.
That shit at the
Charlotte
airport.
Man,
that
got a barbecue spot.
That barbecue spot at that Charlotte airport need to move to Atlanta.
That airport is lit for sure.
I fucks with that shit.
You get that barbecue and you go sit in one of them rocking chairs.
Goddamn right.
Eat like you on the front porch.
Big white rocking chairs in the window.
Mm-hmm.
North Carolina food way better than Atlanta.
You think so?
I haven't had a good
You're just meal. Trying to find any reason not to like Atlanta, and that's some bullshit.
I ordered macaroni and cheese and collard greens, and macaroni and cheese.
You can't eat everybody macaroni. Cows. You know that. You think you just gonna, just because this is a black city, you could just pull up eating people macaroni?
You fucking right. Macaroni.
No, it don't work like that, Mona.
It don't. You just been? Like you probably can't eat everybody cheesesteak.
Exactly.
That's a good point.
What's your favorite cheesesteak place in Philly?
The Poppy Store, like hood stores. Puerto Ricans, a little bit.
So
English.
It ain't none of the chains?
See?
Hell no. Like
which
tourist
Ishka Bibble's and all that shit.
Yeah, Ishka Bibble's pretty good out of all the tourist spots, but
right.
You got a South Philly cheesesteak, you got a North Philly cheesesteak. South Philly is Whiz, that orange cheese. North Philly is white cheese.
Yeah.
Mayonnaise. Uh-huh.
So which is better for you, the white or the yellow cheese?
North Philly, for sure. I'm from North Philly.
Okay.
Philadelphia is a rough city.
It's a great city.
They don't They don't be bullshitting, but they show a lot of love.
Yeah.
When I went to
Philadelphia's a lawyer. They fuck with you, they fuck with you.
Hell yeah. I felt so out of place one time I went to Philly. I was in the barbershop, and I was sitting there. Nigga was cutting my shit. And then everybody in the barbershop started praying. I was just sitting there.
It's a lot of Muslims in Philly.
You got
I'm
the
talking
beard
about
too.
The entire barbershop, the nigga, everybody.
Muslims, right?
Yeah.
All of them.
Yeah.
I was like,
Philly's like six.
Y'all niggas
Muslims
ain't even gonna ask me if I wanted. All right. Fuck me then.
You got that beard, they might have thought you was gonna get down.
They did, and I felt like exactly. They kind of was disappointed that I didn't.
For sure.
The whole mood changed after
yeah.
That.
Yeah. Look at this nigga.
Man, you down here working? In Atlanta?
In Atlanta? Yeah. Comedy theater all weekend.
How's Atlanta like respond after seeing a nigga they've been watching for so long? Cause you know, this city, a lot of niggas come here and they can just do the first part and then they leave. Like, bro, that's the fans you want to be in front of, the rough crowd.
Right.
So I think we done got a bad rep though.
Nah, it's always love.
Yeah.
It's always love. I don't play Atlanta that often. But
you should,
every
though.
Every time. No, I'm about to be doing more, but.
This is one of them markets where it's like if they fuck with you, they let you rock,
no,
bro.
No, 100%. Anytime I'm here, I get love wherever I go. And I've been coming to Atlanta since I left North Carolina, so.
Hell yeah.
Over 20 years.
What's your favorite city?
I love L.A. That's why I live there. I love LA. I love to visit New York. I can't live in New York. It's too fast paced for me.
It is.
I'll be tired after like 6 hours in New York.
Just the cause
you done did 40 things once you touched down.
I don't really do too much shit. That's one thing about it. Mm-hmm. When I go to New York, I give up in the middle. I was like, fuck, man, we gotta walk again. Bro, I'm not going down all them fucking steps. We need to do everything once.
It's a lot.
It's a lot for me.
It's a lot to do.
But it's I'm from the South. I'm used to motherfuckers being that way. It's too much motherfuckers for me.
Atlanta's really fast. It looks like Philadelphia. It's
yeah, the thing about Atlanta is everybody's moving. Ain't nobody really staying in one place too long. But in New York, it's a lot of niggas lingering. A lot of lingering ass niggas. A lot of niggas walking.
He's super aggressive. That nigga like trying to fight me because I wouldn't hit the weed. Like hit the weed, turn it down. He's really offended by that. You don't want to hit my weed, ma?
They do get offended by that. New York niggas get offended if you don't even buy their weed. They'll just give it to you.
For sure.
Yo, I know you ain't want to fuck with me, but I'm just saying. Just take this
just
on
take
me.
Like,
nah, nigga, relax. Your bag dirty. Never buy weed from a nigga if the bag dirty. Like, if the bag look like it's been handled too much.
Your cellophane cloudy, nigga.
Yeah, I don't fuck with that.
Sure.
That mean he been trying to sell it for a long time and anybody bought it. Y'all done got spoiled. Y'all out there with the medical weed and shit.
That shit good.
The shit done went to college.
Medical is overrated. What?
Some of it ain't.
No, the good za is from a felon.
I think you just like hood niggas anyway, Mona.
Damn.
So when you like hood niggas, they weed hit better.
Any excuse to go down there, you know what I mean?
Yeah. You just like dangerous shit.
Just a hood ass nigga.
You ain't.
Swear, bro, you got to do
I think. Oh, just a hood ass nigga.
LA got just good weed. Just give me just the
it's
house.
It's hard to find.
Just give me the house blunt. That shit hit to me.
I like the dispensary weed though, cause like the a lot of niggas don't leave when you buy weed from. What y'all about to do?
Yeah.
Like, no, this ain't that, bro. Keep it moving, man.
Shit,
anytime you call the weed man in LA, they want to hang out and shit. Oh, y'all got some little cuties over here, huh? Bro, we got enough for us. Ain't nothing extra left over here.
That's funny.
J-O-N, play me some pepper, man. You want a Capri Sun or water or something?
I'm good, man. I'm sipping
you
my little
water. What you want?
Capri Sun. Let me get
I knew you wanted one. You just didn't want to say the shit. Motherfuckers always be trying to act like they don't want a Capri Sun.
Hey, why they don't
like
sell Capri Sun by the gallon?
Who?
You not listening.
Capri Sun.
What you say?
Water.
Oh. I thought you had a big ass water.
I just like free shit. Oh. Pile it up. Get my bag,
y'all. She try to clean that pussy
out. Bro, we about to switch the Kool-Aid because we've been drinking Capri Sun too long and they ain't fucking with us, so
damn.
We about to switch our shit
make
to Kool-Aid.
Make me uncomfortable drinking shit I can't see. I saw a bitch on YouTube cut that open. There was doo-doo in it.
What?
Don't believe that.
Google it.
Fake.
What was?
It was brown shit inside of Capri Sun.
Ain't shit in these.
You can't see.
These
you can at the bottom.
These is doo-doo free.
Why you think they made the bottom clear? Because of the doo-doo incident.
Ain't no rats or nothing in this bitch.
It's ain't a joke.
No roaches.
My favorite city, Baltimore. I fuck with Baltimore.
Baltimore, July 31st. It's my first time in Baltimore.
You doing stand-up? What you doing?
Yeah, I'm doing stand-up.
For real?
Mm. Oh,
I
shit.
I fuck with Baltimore.
I'm a comedian. I'm
going to be in your town on the 25th.
Really? Where?
July 25th at the Met.
At the Met. Okay. Mm-hmm. That's North Philly.
Young Philly.
Atlanta got the best comedy crowds.
You think so?
But I think we've got watered down. Like the old Uptown days when they used to boo. That was the best crowd.
That wasn't the best crowd.
You don't think so?
That was stressful.
Because I think if you made it, because if you made it, you was funny.
No.
I ain't mean you was funny.
If
they might have just been too tired to boo you because they done booed everybody. I seen a lot of niggas didn't get booed, but a lot of niggas didn't do good either.
I came up in them days.
Wait, so the crowd was just too tired for doing anything? So
nah, they was saving the boo. The Atlanta crowd be like, who next? Nah, don't boo him. Wait. We got a nigga we can really boo. He ain't the worst. Trust me, he ain't the worst. He ain't the best, but trust me, save your boo, nigga. You gonna need your energy for this next nigga.
Yeah, Uptown, 5,
I got booed
nine.
My second show.
Your second show?
Second show I've ever done comedy.
I haven't had a bad night
Soul
yet.
Crusher.
Yeah.
That's scary for me. I feel like I should have already.
What? You having what?
Like, I had a really bad night, like, when nobody laughs or they're not, like, you know what I mean? Like, I've had times I had to, like, make them laugh, like, work at it. But I haven't had a flop yet.
Like, you gotta make these people laugh. You got to.
Them flops be coming, though, don't
you? Yeah, like, I think it's part of the
game. How long
game.
You been doing it?
3 years.
Oh, yeah, the flops.
Quick PSA for comedians. If you get booed,
Leave.
Well, like, walk off the
like,
stage?
Like, go home. Like,
if you doing bad and you leave, I promise won't nobody be mad at you. I swear.
Like, just drop leave. The mic.
Because they want
no,
you to
no,
leave.
No, don't drop the mic. Like, comedians will do bad and then they'll come sit, like, stand next to you. And it's like bad energy. It's like, get away, bro. Like,
if you bomb, you stay away from people.
Stop. Like, get away.
Bombs
you can feel it.
Shrapnel. Don't bomb
so
and go
finish
right
the
back
set,
over
but
there
then
with
leave
the
club.
Who ain't
no,
went
no,
on
no,
yet.
No, finish your set. No, finish your set.
And y'all say don't finish
no,
your set.
No,
leave. Get the fuck on.
Because they don't want you on the
do
stage.
Do you curse them out first?
No, they don't like you.
You cock-eyed bitch.
Tell that shit.
Just leave.
I mean, if you,
I have it planned out already.
If you feeling it.
I always bring a cousin.
You could do a Bill
Burr. Just in case you got to back me out that bitch. Ba, ba, ba.
Bill Burr did that one time. He was getting booed, and he just started cussing everybody out, and they started laughing.
That's my
plan. But everybody can't do that.
I could fight a little bit.
And he white.
He white.
But you know the thing? I like to see comedians bomb.
You an evil nigga.
That is.
Because I know how hard this shit is. It's hard as fuck. And everybody thinks they can do it.
Everybody so
when I see a nigga dying, I go get front row. I like to just watch him die.
Every nigga or the niggas that
like, when a nigga's dying, like, I can stop me. I got to see this nigga die. And then when they get off of stage and they start talking to you, it's like a ghost is talking to you.
Damn, that's cold-blooded.
And that's the evil side.
That's
every
evil.
Comedian know, like, they like to see a nigga, because it's hard, bro. This shit is hard.
Mm-mm. Everybody.
When I see a comedian bombing, that shit crushes my spirit. I'd be like Trey yelling in the alley, Ricky!
Yeah, that's how I feel.
I don't want to see that
I get
for
secondhand embarrassment. Like,
my feelings are I start sweating for them.
Yeah, exactly.
Especially if it's one of the dogs. One of
now, when it's a comedian I know, I'm like, damn.
Don't backtrack.
No,
you like watching your homies die.
No, I don't like watching my homies
die. You like watching your homies
die. I like watching comedians that think they nice and then they go die.
Oh, okay.
Because we get a lot of that on the road. Yeah. Like, niggas will come up to us, and I'm known for the giving niggas the mic. Like, they'd be like, yo, I'm a comedian, I'm da da da. I'm like, oh, word. High five.
Dang.
Get that.
Quick five.
Could they really take the mic?
Could they be talking?
You can die.
Every time, right?
You can die in 3 minutes. You can die really in 2 minutes.
Yo, don't they almost every time take the mic, right?
Yeah.
And I think we've only had, like, maybe one or two that was nice. Everyone else.
Yeah, you gotta let them
all
get them guest spots.
You got to,
though. You don't want them niggas to blow up and be like, yeah, Karlous bitch ass. Nigga ain't wanna let me on. Now I'm running shit. Ho ass nigga try to stop my career, man.
You know that's going on the gram for sure.
Nah, for sure.
Oh, I used to host comedy shows. Nigga can come up and bomb and don't have one complete joke and get off stage and bomb. It was like, yeah, that nigga Karlous ain't bring me up right, man.
He
ain't tell him who I was. You know, like, he ain't say nothing, you know what
it's
I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
Yeah. Then the nigga did 2 minutes right before I came up. You feel me? So I'm on a whole nother vibe. You feel me? And then mix that shit with what he said and then he ain't bring me up right. And the DJ ain't play my song. Then the mic was fucking up a little bit, so man.
All them bomb excuses.
All the bomb excuses.
Oh,
this the funniest shit to hear when a nigga bombing though.
Them niggas is handed me a right-handed mic, man.
Man, when a
I'm
nigga
left-handed.
Hey, when a nigga bomb, when a nigga bomb, this is what the nigga always say. No matter who it is, a nigga be bombing. Nigga always say, yeah, man. I just came up here to show my nigga Karlous some love, man. Man, nigga, now you fuck you, man. I just came up here to show y'all some love, man.
What do y'all think about the social media comics? Like, people that come up.
This the
like
thing
me.
About it. Leave them alone.
Yeah, leave them alone.
That's, you can't, this like, somebody is telling all the social media comedians that they have to go do stand-up comedy. If you're not a stand-up comedian, don't let nobody talk you into that shit.
But they going for the bag.
I don't blame them though.
Nigga. I don't blame them either because some of them making a lot of money.
They stupid then. These people got a fucking demand. If people want to book you and you do sketches on social media, the bitches need to know that you coming to do sketches then.
Facts.
Shoot sketches in front of these motherfuckers and put everybody who was gonna boo you in the goddamn sketch.
Facts.
Don't let these people book you for an hour of comedy if you ain't never did a minute of comedy. I show up at these motherfucking schools with a production team. Yeah, we shooting sketches this whole time. I'm gonna need these people over here to put these black t-shirts on. And y'all, okay, this was y'all. Nigga, do what the fuck you been doing.
Facts.
Why would you goddamn let somebody talk you out the hustle that you been on?
Facts, man.
Man, I'll book these motherfucking colleges and be like, look, I don't do no stand-up comedy, but I will come and be on campus for 2 hours and I'll shoot some sketches with some students and I'm out there, bitch. You're going to get more promotion that way if the shit go my way than if somebody say, man, that nigga came to school and bomb. Like, no, that nigga came to the school and turned this bitch up and we went viral, nigga.
Facts.
Why wouldn't you?
Facts.
Fuck that shit, bro. Like, I'm a stand-up comedian. I'm not about to let these people say, okay, Los, we need you for the homecoming fashion show. Don't curse. Man, fuck all that. Fuck that. Don't book me if you watching the shit that I say. Why would you bring me somewhere that you don't want me to say this shit?
I like the cuss.
Stop hiring comedians and trying to tell them what to say. Hey, could you watch the bitches? What could it not be so many bitches in here? I mean, we're fine with the language. Just don't call them hoes. They fucking ain't they? It's kids in the show. They holding babies. Fuck out of here.
I feel like I'm a lover of comedy. I feel like the comedians I watched coming up told jokes in little clubs for 15, 10 years, whatever. People like me, I went viral from the beginning. So it's like, if I say, yo, meet me in Baltimore, they gonna meet me in Baltimore.
Yeah, you know what I mean? But you gotta do something when they get there.
Here's the thing. You get booked for 45 minutes. You gotta do at least, that's the contract. At comedy clubs, it's 45 minutes. That's the minimum.
Or at least tell these motherfuckers, hey, keep it real. I don't do no stand-up comedy. I needed this
45
money.
45 minutes of comedy.
Nigga, you suck. Take a picture with everybody in that bitch.
Getting booked.
Give them a reason to love you.
Getting booked is easy.
What's that, though?
There's
like, I'm doing, it's all me, like the street. So I'm getting the venue, I'm getting the security.
Right.
It's my shit. I booked myself.
Right.
Because niggas ain't calling me.
Right.
I did the punchline in Philadelphia. I fucked the punchline up.
Right.
Them niggas wasn't gonna call me.
You don't need them to call you.
Comedy is male dominated.
They not gonna call you.
And then on top of it being I'm male dominated, I'm a viral comedian. So the comedians that's local to me, they not inviting or wanting. I've tried.
Exactly. They're not supposed to. You know how many of these people who you think supposed to call you don't have no idea you even want to do comedy?
Fuck call you. I'm saying I have came and really been like, yo, I'm a fan of yours. You're a legend here. I want to open for you.
You shouldn't have told them that. You fucked up when you told them that.
You really from Philadelphia.
Yeah, you here.
You sound like Freeway. Like, sometimes you be talking, I think she's gonna give a, like, cut the beat, yeah?
Ain't nobody gonna just be like, you wanna open for me? For real?
My kids hungry, snatch the dishes off your kitchen.
You hopeful? Go out there and do your best, and I'll do the rest.
But here's what I say about social media comedians, because it's two different things. I agree with y'all, like, if you're not a stand-up comedian and you get booked to do an hour and a headline, you should be smart enough to not do that. You should do what you're strongest at.
You should take $1,000 of that deposit money that they sent you and hire a nigga to write you some material.
Mm. No, but like, some of them do though, some of them do. But here's the thing.
But still, you're not gonna be nice. Even with somebody writing your shit, it takes some seasoning to be on stage for a whole hour.
But at least you'll have enough shit to say when you get there.
If you remember it, because you're going to be so goddamn nervous because you're not conditioned for it.
Right.
It's like having a boxer come in, a professional boxer, show you all the punches, but you get in that goddamn ring for the first 30 seconds, you're going to be gassed.
Oh, I don't advocate for none of these niggas to goddamn manipulate the comedy game, because you can't.
What I'm going to say is this. Look. There's also the question that I always get, like, do you think the social media comedians are funny? And my thing is, yeah. There's some who are funny and there's some who are not. The same way coming up in the Def Comedy Jam era, whatever era you were in, whoever, you know, if we're supposed to be the realist in the traditional era, there was garbage niggas then too. And there was great niggas then too. So every era, whatever platform you use, there's going to be the good and the bad. You know, if hip hop niggas would have stopped when the 70s band niggas was like, nah, y'all just gonna be a fad. Y'all cheating and y'all using our music and y'all just spitting words over it and that's not real music. If they would have listened to that shit and got discouraged and stopped doing it, we wouldn't be sitting here.
That's a fact.
We wouldn't be sitting in this room.
That's a fact.
Because hip hop Even though they didn't like it at the time, now they're getting with it. Now they, you know.
And real musicians laughed at them too.
Just real musicians was like, man, fuck them little niggas.
Because I'm a stand-up comedian, and sometimes I be wanting to do some shit too, because them niggas look like they're having a lot of fun in them sketches. They be sucking real titties and shit. They be having the OnlyFans girls on there.
And some of them are repetitive and boring.
They be slapping girls on the booty.
There's some good ones and some
bad ones.
But I don't like no play.
They be getting to touch real boys in them sketches.
I actually like to do stand-up.
Fuck them sketches.
That was the way.
But the stand-up comedian would be like, fuck them sketches. Them niggas ain't even got no punchline.
But see, I do sketch. I do sketch too.
They just got nice, pretty visuals.
I do it all.
That's the thing, Los. I'd be like, fuck them sketches.
Fuck them.
But you gotta, but it's like, it's almost like the new, it's the new
but
one.
But see, they do skits.
They do skits, yeah.
Well, I mean, skits.
Nigga, we play baby basketball. Sketches. They doing, they doing.
I'm from the Living Color School, so we do sketches.
There you go.
Minutes long.
Yeah, that's why me and Spice will do
it. Wait,
so
hour. What's the real difference between a skit and a skit?
A skit is a baby skit.
Skit is baby, exactly.
It's like the, okay.
And it's
typically not as funny.
Yeah, exactly.
Because
I
feel like
it's not as well thought out.
For me to do a sketch, I needed to be creative. I needed to be. People call me sketches. I have to be the baby mom. We're gonna knock shit off on the shelf on Walmart, and we're gonna get put out. Like that's really what people bring in. It's like for me, I needed to fit.
I would have you be a lawyer. Or a doctor, or somebody respectable in the community.
With them same nails.
Yep. Because it would be so unbelievably believable. Mm-hmm.
I'm scared of them, but I like them.
I feel like you could be in a movie as like...
Don't touch me with that shit.
The bus driver with a big booty. Like, they'll put you in a movie with some white people, you're just gonna have to be an aggressive black woman giving them life advice. Like, look, bitch!
They like that.
Go get your man! Exactly, you take over. You'd be in four movies doing this shit.
But that'll be... Hey!
It'll be hard. White people love aggressive black women in their face trying to give them life advice. And somebody got to get punched in the face. That's
why people love anything we do. We set the tone for everything, the culture. We make things.
I'm about to find a way to manipulate racism to my advantage.
That's why when y'all talk about people, the bigwig saying no, how can a bigwig say no? We create the culture. We control the culture. I think things are changing in that way as well.
They mind trick you.
We got to start tricking white people.
They mind trick you into thinking that they're in control.
We got to start tricking white people into doing shit that we don't even like, just to see if they're going to really do it.
They're in control of the finance.
True.
But we got to start doing some wild. The shit is all I'm saying.
Like do you know it's been our whole plot?
Like next winter, I feel like niggas should just dress like cowboys the whole winter. I'm talking about all the way down. Like,
unannounced, surprising.
And then just then when white people start doing it like we do, just stop doing that shit all of a sudden. It's like, boy, y'all lame as hell wearing that goof ass shit.
I like that.
And we should just come out with some motherfucking chicken hats or something outrageous so we can clearly see that they stealing this shit from us. Nigga, we start wearing chicken hats and next thing you look up, Louis Vuitton chicken hats is $2,500. It's just, I don't know, bro.
Look at the body. Look at bodies. Look at what white women's bodies now. Their lips, their hips, their legs. Like, we already know.
But even our skinny women finer than they skinny women. We can take, fuck all the plastic surgery women. We'll take 100 skinny black women and put them up against 100 skinny white women. No surgery, no makeup. We still gonna win.
For sure.
1,000%.
For sure.
I like me a little slim.
We've been thinking
too.
About how to beat the white man. Like yeah.
Bruh, it's not even the white man.
Who is it?
You don't even understand, bruh. America, if you fucking do the same shit these white people doing, you'll be straight.
And what is that?
Nigga, anytime you see a bunch of white people doing some shit, do that.
TikTok.
Whatever it is, nigga, do it.
Lacrosse.
We not being American enough. That's why we not enjoying this shit.
White people don't wear their masks. They don't wear masks.
Who don't then? You know what I mean? I'm going to be like, that's right, brother. That's right.
You're trying
take
to control
take that goddamn mask off. Just don't understand how this shit work.
I
go
think
to
we should
Starbucks,
start calling the police
man.
On them more, though.
Man.
Like, when they walk by, lock the door.
You gotta lock the door.
They grouping up in the park, call the police. It's a bunch of people in this park, and they're passing around a ball. Might be
police
stuff with cocaine.
But they don't comprehend that. White people don't comprehend that.
I'm not talking about
they're
that. You're a black person. You will never be able to call the police, so don't ever do that.
Nope.
I'm just saying.
They're not gonna do shit to the white people anyway.
You just have to take advantage of what white people call freedoms. Like, you have to be, go get you a registered gun license.
Mm. If you
join the NRA. Buy you a truck. Put you a big ass American flag out in front of your house, man.
Why don't we get a Confederate
fuck
one too?
Yeah, that's the only way you gonna get any peace in this bitch. You got to be American, bro. We ain't been American enough.
You lock
we gotta up. Get when white people get mad about some shit, we gotta show up mad too. Man. You right! Taxes high than a motherfucker, and we need these credits. Only
flag
way.
Flag is weird. It's a loser flag.
You fucking
lost.
Right.
Who would flag the loser flag? It doesn't make any sense.
It don't matter.
They lost.
Do right? What the if you want to be it. If you ain't leaving, just do what the fuck they doing. I'm not saying it's gonna make your life better. It's just gonna buy you some time.
I'ma just stay a nigga.
Stay
me
a nigga.
Too. And they say I look white. They know I'm not white. They follow me around the store.
They're gonna be over that white shit in 1 minute. That could be across, maybe from across the street. They're like, is she white? Oh, she's clearly not.
Yes.
It ain't even white people
soon
who got this shit fucked up.
So I open my
soon as you open your
sometimes
mouth.
Sometimes I don't even open my mouth. My earrings are big.
It's over. We just got to start taking advantage of this shit.
Well, no, they follow you because they like, is she white?
And stop acting as people are they mixed. That's rude. Did you know that? Because it you, is. They my think you mixed? Business. Say hello before you say, are you white?
They touch you?
Yes, because you can see the fingerprint. They do that. People do that to me. Hence the name, don't call me white girl. I'm 100% black. I like
100?
It. 100? 100. I have as much white in me as you have in you.
No, I don't have no white in me.
Oh, you got some white in you. It's impossible. Mm-hmm.
I ain't got no white
how?
In me. How? I got
white. Hey, you remember
did you go to ancestry.com?
You remember
you
Forrest
really
Gump? When he was showing you all his ancestors that died in the war and it was the same motherfucker over and over again? That's what my family looked like. A bunch of niggas my height. Bald head. And a granddaddy looked just like me.
So first there's black, not a drop of white in you.
First
you know
black
for
man
fact.
To own a horse in North Mississippi. My great, great, great granddaddy stole
gotta,
it from a white
look
man.
Up your ancestry.
Got all kind of black history in my family. You ever heard of a Jerry Curl?
Yeah.
You don't know Jerry last name?
What?
Miller.
That's hard.
I'm a staple in black history, bro. My great,
Jerry Miller.
My great, great, great great granddaddy was the first black man to put some house speakers in a car.
These random Negro facts.
Yeah, random Negro facts. Hell yeah.
And your family marched with Dr. King too, right?
Hell yeah. Right there with him.
He's solid.
He's in the back though.
My grandmother was squirted with a fire hydrant on Turner Street.
For real?
Mm-hmm. With a hydrant?
Yeah, they told their little asses to move and they sprayed them with fire and they flew. Mm.
Damn. My great uncle sold some weed to a couple of civil rights leaders.
That's cool.
He wouldn't tell me exactly which ones, he just know. He said when they used to come to town that they used to hit him up and he'd bring them the business.
So he was the nigga that
they used to hit him up.
He did.
Was the plug.
This
in the civil rights movement arena.
Yeah.
Right. They knew who to call.
My granddaddy told me he was selling weed since the 50s.
Wow.
Mm. They called it hash back then.
Reefer.
Reefer, yeah. It came rolled up. You get a couple blunts for $5 in a paper bag.
Joints, he said joints was a dollar then.
Damn. Take me back.
Probably with some bullshit.
Y'all remember Arizona? People act like they don't remember that. Around 2004, 2003, we smoked Arizona. It was only haze, and it was Arizona.
That was y'all. We had,
I never smoked shit.
He never smoked.
Smoke
he be dancing.
That's what's up. So no smoking at all.
You drink this nigga's age just be dancing.
Nah.
He gonna live forever. That man dance, do karate, one finger push up. He the one who got everybody on that flat
so
earth
you drink
theory.
Green shit. Wake up in the morning, do crunches.
Nah. I do drink green shit though.
Okay.
He be doing that shit where you have to get on your elbows.
But I
do that very well. Do it again.
Mona, what the fuck is wrong with you? I'm not giving you none of this dick, okay?
Don't
try to hate handsome your way. You done already talked yourself out of this, Mona. You got random niggas cash apping you and
that's
shit.
That's true.
You not ready for me.
This nigga don't use microwaves.
He don't?
He's smart, because this shit's not good for you.
He used that iPhone, though. All the radiation is right there. I might as well warm your food up while you getting this shit.
Right. This nigga don't use the microwave, man.
He don't trust the government. And I don't blame him.
I fucking love
him. You know how much patience you gotta have to not use the microwave?
My grandmother
it ain't that goddamn long, nigga.
That shit long as hell.
Air fryer.
Toaster oven.
You got an air fryer?
Not yet.
Do you not use a microwave because of the radioactive shit?
Yeah. Why am I going to swallow radiation?
Exactly.
Sure, we got phones. Yeah, that's fucking us up too. But it's on the outside.
Right.
And you just going to welcome? When you go to get an x-ray, they put that big ass lid
right,
on your motherfucking ass.
You. And if you're pregnant, you can't get it.
That's what I'm saying. So you going to eat the fucking radiation?
Not only do I eat it, I set
it with
over
some pasta sauce, nigga. It's mixed into the pasta sauce. You drinking and eating fucking.
I'm watching it too, because I wait. That like should I watch be good it bubble. That's how I know when to take it out when it bubbles.
That shit be too hot. That's how you know this shit killing you. Like microwave gets shit.
You never been to jail.
Mm-mm. No, I ain't never been to jail.
This is a good dude.
That's different for me. You know what I mean?
No, he ain't never even been
you
in
made
there.
The grilled cheese with the iron?
I made fucking deep dish pizza in a
how
microwave.
How long was you in there, mom?
I did a year.
Damn.
Twice.
You did a year twice?
I probably came and spoke to you in one of them prisons.
I was on six in Market.
I used to come down there with Charlie Mack, and we was always in the juvenile prisons talking
about. No, she was in the big girl prison.
I'm a grown ass woman, though.
You look young as fuck. Take the compliment, nigga.
How you make that deep dish pizza in there?
Right.
Listen, so you take tortillas, right? Because that's you sell your tortillas, and then if you get little spicy beef sausages, and then you take ketchup and you mix that with salsa and a little sugar. That's your marinara. So you do your first layer with your meat and the cheese that you stole from the kitchen. Cheddar. Then you do another layer. You might do some fried onions, you know, put some veggies
where
in it.
Where the fuck you get all these ingredients from? You in prison.
I stole them out the kitchen because I worked there.
So you smuggling everything.
I put adobo by the cat and rolled that bitch up on the elevator.
Okay.
And it was a good time, you know what I'm saying?
I hear you. I'm not interested, but I hear
so you. Had
I've never, ever, ever, ever in my life been around so many fucking women. And it was pretty terrible. But you know in jail a lot, people do, to pass time, they fuck. Especially in girl jail, especially the married women. Like, if your wife's in prison, she writes you long letters, she's fucking some big woman named Bruce. Because the women have beards there, you know what I mean? Y'all look shocked.
Bro, when the last time you heard a female prison story?
That's my first one.
Like 2 seconds ago.
They just go to jail?
That's the first and the last.
People say, you too crazy. Mister, people say you too pretty to go to jail.
Was you laughing
a bunch
or you low-key trying to suck my dick just now?
I was definitely laughing.
You lean all the way over.
I ain't that big of a fan. Yeah. I like
it's
your talent.
It's a lot of pretty women in jail?
It's a lot of gorgeous women
I was
women
in the right
in
position, too. I was like.
No.
Bro, this shit, wow.
Yeah.
Every time we try to have a nice, civil conversation.
I've seen a woman get fisted in jail. No cap, it's jail, what the fuck? What else you gonna do? You fuck, you eat. Do a couple crunches. You know what I mean?
Just passing time.
Bitches go to jail, let's move on.
With a fist in.
She said, let's move
none
on.
None of y'all know nobody been in
so
jail.
So, it's women in jail.
No.
I was in the same jail as Little Kim.
Making deep dish pieces with stolen ingredients.
Also handmade dildos made out of pens, pads, and rubber gloves.
What?
You take pens and pencils as the base. You wrap them around with sanitary napkins so it could be soft. Then you take a rubber glove, put it on top, another one on the bottom, and you have you a dildo, sir. If you want to get fancy, you can make you a strap on. How else you gonna fuck your wife? People be married in jail, especially the women that have men. Like the men that come see her every weekend and shit. She got a hickey. She says she broke out. No, her fucking husband upstairs is giving her that shit. Big Bruce. My first celly was like 350 pounds. She was from D.C. And she was a man. She had both lockers filled. And she said, you can't get a locker, but you're welcome to get whatever. And I need you to hold me down sometimes. So I would sit in front of the door while she fucked people loudly.
She got it made. Yeah. Big Bruce is the motherfucking
from D.C.
Man.
Shout out to you. You watching this.
She ain't try to fuck you?
No, she didn't. In jail, it's always like a family thing, girl jail, so she was my dad. And my dad did a lot of time in jail, so I remember calling him, and I'd be on the phone with him, and I'm like, Dad, something. He's like, no, don't call them bitches dad. It was too late, she was already my dad.
So you called your celly dad?
That was my dad, nigga. We had two lockers. She ordered everything for the room. And we just shared.
No, so how long you was in there?
A year.
And you ain't get fucked by nobody?
No, I never dated a woman yet. I'm on my way. And it's close, Avion.
Okay. That's not my name, but I mean, I hear
she called that nigga like, A-Ron.
No, I did not.
Oh.
I said Affion. Your name's not Affion?
No.
What is it?
Affion.
Oh, it's Affion.
Yeah.
She from Philly.
So I use the F instead of a V.
Yeah, and there's never a V in that motherfucker.
Affion. Mm-hmm. I mean, I'm close. I know your name. I know you, Affion.
Yeah, I got you. Yeah. But you put a V in that motherfucker, and that's not my name.
Affion. I got it.
It's like calling this nigga Darlos Miller.
No way.
I don't go by that no more. I used to go by Darlos.
It's different.
Damn.
It's a different letter. It's all good.
That nigga used to go by Darlos.
I just can't believe these women is in there. That's not bad. Women want some dick. They in there making ink pen dicks, man. And they say we'll fuck anything.
For sure, ink pen dicks.
Nigga, the ink pen dicks with the so same.
So there's a lot of sex. It's a lot of sex in God jail too, but y'all not gonna believe that.
Nah, I seen the
yeah, that's why we doing our best to stay out that motherfucker.
Me too.
That's enough to make a nigga be like, what's
the law? I was in jail 10 plus years ago. That's a long time ago. I was
nigga,
a kid.
Shit.
Nah, I ain't trying to break none of that
no.
shit.
People make mistakes.
I'm okay on the outside. I like life.
Me too. Here. I haven't been in a while.
So was y'all penalized for like when they come and raid y'all shit and they see these dildos?
Yeah. Anything, everything's contraband. If you have a state issue shirt and you fucking put a little roll in it, it's contraband. You know what I mean? Adobo, salt and pepper is contraband. All that's contraband. Happiness is contraband. Like jail is terrible. The way they treat people in jail is terrible, too. We have more people in jail here in the United States than anywhere else in the continent. That's why we should treat
We got more better. People fucking up.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean that they just get treated like shit. You deserve your rights, your religious rights. You deserve
But they making
meal,
money
your
off,
piece of
off everybody here in
exactly.
jail.
Exactly. Huge money just US. To feed them and don't feed them apple. You don't get an apple.
Privatized prison.
It's been times a whole month. Exactly. It's been times a whole month where I don't have any fruit and vegetables. That's wrong.
Y'all making pieces.
Deep dish with tortillas.
We need to pay more attention
salt.
To the niggas behind the wall, how they being treated. I think
I'm
we
just
do.
Saying, can you plug us with some of the bad bitches that's in prison so we can start sending them some on the world? You know what I'm saying? I don't feel like just
the
because
sad the, part is some of them are still in jail because I was in jail
I know,
for
and I
want
to try to build
years.
Some relationships with them before they get out here.
I got you. I got a couple names. Good.
I'm talking about the beautiful ones that you were talking about,
I
not the ones
you.
That was getting fisted and Bruce now.
You don't want Bruce information?
No. No.
Bruce and him get the same lineup from the barber.
Yeah, give
right
me the
here,
Bruce.
Nigga.
Give me the Bruce.
Yeah, the Bruce.
Bring my shit up a little bit like Bruce shit was.
Shout out to Bruce and DC.
Oh. Damn, Moni, you just had a rough life.
I have been through some shit.
Well, we're glad you're out here with us this summer.
Me too.
Man.
Last summer too, you saying like I'm fresh home.
I'm just
I've been
saying.
In trouble for 10
what was the
years.
First thing you did when you got home?
Got fucked.
So fuck eating
happily.
I didn't eat shit. I got fucked.
Bring him, man.
I skipped to it.
You imagine you got some fresh out of jail pussy on the way?
Yeah, we not even getting to the crib.
I ain't done. That's some shit I ain't
never
had.
I've never missed so much in my life. I didn't realize I liked it so much until I couldn't have it. No, nothing would have made me take CO dick because them niggas fucking too. Them COs are fucking.
What?
The COs fuck you. The correctional officers, the police, they'll fuck you. They give you extra milks and fuck you.
Extra milk?
Yeah.
That's some pimping.
Oh!
Damn.
Bitch, you want this vitamin D or not?
That's the shit you should have been telling me.
I mean, we making jokes about it, but it's sad.
Bitch.
It's terrible. It's a terrible thing.
I'm gonna give you 100% dick for this 2%. Bitch.
You in jail for 5 years.
Bend
and
over.
Fuck this sloppy, fat ass CO for some milks.
That nigga ain't never quitting his job.
Fuck no, that's why they got him. A lot of weak men like that get CO and cop jobs. Y'all know that. They're weirdos.
20 years.
There's a guy from high school that didn't talk to anybody and people smack the shit out of the back of his head every day.
It'd be
at
like
lunch.
That scene
that's
set
who
it
the
off
state trooper
when Jada
is.
Needed the money for the brother Karlous.
I'm in a bind, Nate.
I'm in a bind, Nate.
I'm in a bind,
well,
Nate.
Bitch, if you want this milk, you know what you gotta do.
That was
you
terrible.
You don't want to work for
Luther. And that bastard didn't go to school. That was terrible. You don't know what I did to get this fucking money. Make you look at your mom different a little bit, don't
you? Be in that shower crying.
Mommy had to do some shit to get them bills paid.
Damn.
You know
wonder
what
why you had so many fucking uncles. Them ain't your uncles. Your mother got one brother. She was fucking them. She was fucking them in to get you on that school trip. You want a hoagie?
I ain't grow up like that.
I ain't grow up like that, dude.
No.
But you know who mama got at the worst in the movies? Forrest Gump, mama. She was getting her ass towed out.
I think it was
school
necessary.
Principal fucked.
Yeah, she had to do that.
She had to do that.
She got that nigga some legs. She fucked him some legs. That there is a legend. That the last time you heard a bitch fucking for some lean. That nigga had polio. You know how bad polio was back then?
She got that nigga legs back. She was making him believe that he was.
Right.
It's part of the game.
Forrest Gump mama was a hoe.
Fucking matriarch.
She was a hoe.
She did what she had to do.
See how big that bitch house was? She ain't never worked.
Mm-mm.
I think she got it. Fuck it. She didn't know who his father was either.
She didn't.
Hey, it
That's
worked.
Why she named him Forrest.
It worked.
Yes, it worked.
Forrest Gump went around the world, nigga. Twice.
Sure.
He ran one time.
Own franchises and shit. Successful.
All American.
All off that mom's cat.
Had his mama not fucked that man, he wouldn't have been at that school.
Met the president.
Never would have made it to the University of Alabama.
Ping pong champ.
Come on, man. Saved 100 people in a war.
I was running.
That's a good ass movie.
It's one of those ones that you don't mind watching it wherever you at in life.
For sure.
It's much
nigga, you could be sitting at the bar, toe up, nigga, like, nigga, they got Forrest Gump on there. Hell no, they my boy right here. Why Lieutenant Dan jump out that bed with no legs?
Lieutenant Dan. He smacked the prostitute.
What?
He get mad.
With no legs. He slapped the shit out that bitch.
He forgot,
Forrest
right
Gump beat a motherfucker up like Takeoff when that nigga tried to grab Jenny.
Yeah.
All you saw was Forrest coming through that bitch like this.
At the Black Panther meeting.
What?
Yeah.
That's sorry, a good one. I ruined your Black Panther party.
That's a good piece of cinema.
You know who known for big titties now that's black?
Oh,
Z,
it ain't
Sherry,
even me.
Look.
It's this nigga.
Look, bro. Sherry Shepherd.
This nigga went back to an hour and 15 minutes ago.
Nah, because I was trying to, y'all didn't know, I couldn't think of one.
But there's
wasn't
still thinking. No black woman
Sherry
that has the
Shepherd
label, though. No black woman has the label.
As a big titty, yeah.
Huh?
There's still no woman that's just known for
yeah,
big titties.
Yeah, Sherry Shepherd.
Nah.
I don't know who she
is. We know that she has
from
big titties,
view.
But what I'm saying is there's no black woman that's known when you say her name, oh, the titty girl, like Dolly right. Parton. Dolly Parton is synonymous with titties.
Whoopi Goldberg has some big titties, too.
He is bugging. Nobody even looks at her titty area. She's just not that type of woman.
I love her, man. I ain't never looked at Whoopi like that.
I love Whoopi
Goldberg.
Whoopi
don't
though.
Give you that.
Bro, you just can't be out here looking at Whoopi
don't
Goldberg.
Don't discuss
like
her titties
that.
Like that.
Brian, you need help.
Don't touch
boy.
Whoopi. That's where y'all draw the line.
You don't have no, you just whatever with it.
It's fucking
you
Whoopi
loose,
Goldberg.
Bro.
Damn.
Hey, this your partner.
Who?
This
guy?
Silly.
I claim him, man. That's my nigga, but you know,
he
I don't
just
know
randomly
where his mind be going when he when
look,
the titty.
Right, look, if you had to, if you had to pick one, Whoopi Goldberg or Queen Latifah.
We still going. This is crazy. Y'all gonna disrespect
that's
Whoopi like that.
That's a fucked up choice. Which one though?
Don't even entertain.
That's not a fuck
Whoopi
up,
or
is that a certain point you have to stop?
Whoopi or queen?
I'm
bro.
Rocking with the queen on that one.
On which ones you would rather suck?
Whoopi Goldberg or Queen Latifah?
Queen beautiful.
Whoopi Goldberg don't
queen
even
Latifah
have
beautiful, man.
Whoopi Goldberg love this show, man.
Queen beautiful and Whoopi's legend.
If you can't not do it, man.
I'm not doing either one.
My favorite Whoopi movie is the movie with the white guy. She has the kid by him and she don't really know.
Ted Danson. Fuck Ted Danson.
Fuck him.
My favorite Whoopi Goldberg movie is Burglar.
Ghost.
Ghost or something.
Mine was Eddie, because I was an extra in that motherfucker.
Hey.
Really? That's lit. You did something with Whoopi, that's fucking lit.
I was a basketball courtside photographer. You can see me, I'm real blurry in one of the shots. It's beautiful.
Hustler.
It's fucking
hustler. You thought that was gonna be one of the ones?
Nah, but I was doing all the dumb extra shit, like trying to go eat with the main cast.
Hey, what was the job you thought was gonna be the one?
All of them, nigga.
No, did you see?
Same thing, yeah. Not when I was doing the extra work, but yeah, when I first started booking shit, I thought Def Jam. I thought that was gonna be, oh, nigga, I'm on now, nigga. I'm the new Chris Tucker, nigga. Nope. You gotta work.
Gotta work.
You gotta put in work. You know what I'm saying? But I'm thankful for every job, though. Every job is a building block.
Is Netflix special, like, or that big special, is that the pinnacle for people, that big comedy special, the hour on?
I don't know. I don't know which one. I don't know how niggas pick their favorite. I told you which one gonna be my favorite. The biggest check.
The last one.
The biggest one.
But
the money.
I definitely want the special.
The formula has changed, though. Back in the day, the formula was Def Jam, get on the
sitcom,
And then you out of there. And then you go to the movies. Yeah. That's how it was. It was like Martin, he did Def Jam, then he did the movies, then he had his special. Or no, his specials then, well, kind of the same simultaneously, specials and movies in the other.
Right.
I don't think Mark that show gets enough flowers. Like that shit is still. That's one of the greatest. Yeah, that shit on right. It's
on right now. You see the hoodie? That big homie sent this to me himself.
Oh, that's what's up.
Yeah,
he did.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. He sent me shit.
Like that show, that moment in time, watching that shit.
He came to my stand-up special. He sat in the crowd. I was like, I don't give a fuck what none of y'all niggas say. Martin Lawrence is in my, is in the audience of my special.
That's crazy.
I don't give a fuck what y'all say about me. Big homie stamped it.
Yeah, that's crazy. That's sure.
Martin Lawrence.
Well, J. Anthony Brown sent me some hot sauce.
That's valid.
You sent valid too.
Yeah. Goddamn right.
I was on there with some niggas. I be around the legends and shit too.
You stamped. You
J. Anthony Brown is a legend though. He got a club in there. Hell yeah,
J Spot. I was doing the J Spot when didn't nobody give a fuck.
Watch out now.
He wasn't even there.
Jay a legend.
Yeah.
Shout out to Jimmy Brown.
I did the J Spot before they remodeled the bitch.
Mm.
The stage was on the other side.
Facts.
Jay watched the show too.
One night I was in that bitch, they got to fighting at somebody's birthday party, nigga, they tore that bitch up.
They remodeled that bitch more.
For real. They was throwing bottles around that bitch. It was a crazy ass night. I liked the J Spot.
I like it too.
One day I got high and I was just walking around. I fucked around and walked past the J Spot. I was like, I done walked too far. I walked far as fuck. I don't know why. I was just walking. And that ain't even know where you need to be walking at.
At all, that's Inglewood.
Nah, not over there. But at least if you're on that side and you keep going west, it's a little better than if you go to the east. If you go on the other side of the 405.
Anything south of Wilshire is dangerous.
I feel like every street is dangerous.
Everywhere.
Yeah.
Right now.
I just feel like it's a lot of tension out there because ain't nowhere to park.
Especially in L.A.
Damn, that's a good theory.
Especially.
You know how frustrating it is to be a homeowner and you can't park in front of your house but once a week?
That's crazy.
Right.
That's crazy.
You gotta put your shit on the other side of the street. That shit is.
You gotta put shit in your spot like cement and shit, like big hunks of cement. That's how we do in Philadelphia. Put big chairs. Sometimes you just put your kids in the spot.
Mm-mm. Not in L.A.
Play Double Dutch
in
right
L.A.,
here,
they you can't park on the street one day out the week because the street sweeping. So you got to maneuver and find other parking on streets that will allow it. And that is the most goofy-ass policy ever.
It don't suck.
Is it the same day for everybody or is it alternate days?
No, alternate, like Monday, Wednesdays.
They let you know when you move in.
We get street sweeping once a fucking year.
They like, get your ass up.
The funny thing is I lived in neighborhoods in LA that don't have street sweeping and the streets are cleaner than the ones that got the goddamn sweeping.
This is Atlanta, you clean your own fucking streets.
Atlanta's pretty clean, it seemed dirty to me.
Yeah, sometimes.
Depending on what corner you on.
Exactly.
I didn't visit the hood this trip.
Good. I gotta show you some better shit about Atlanta because you're not about to leave here.
You're never here, Karlous.
I know.
I text you, I'm here. You say, I'm in Africa.
And I'd be in Africa.
You in Atlanta or you in Gwinnett? That's a big difference.
I was in Buckhead.
Like, that's nice. That shit used to be nice in the 90s.
Facts.
That shit that fell off so bad.
It looks pretty nice to me.
That's the most dangerous part of Atlanta now.
It is.
There used to be niggas running down the street. There was a shootout. Niggas just shooting at anybody. Shooter was caught. No motive. Nigga just mad shooting people as they pass by. Don't.
Yeah, Buckhead used to
That's
be
That's crazy awkward. How Lenox is the worst mall now. It's the best mall, but it's the worst mall.
Y'all got metal detectors now,
right? No, it's not
now,
the best mall. It just has the best shit in it.
What's the best mall?
You mean tell you the most slept on mall, consistent mall that always then came through for niggas in Georgia and nobody ever mentioned it?
West End.
Cumberland. Cumberland Mall got you fresh when you couldn't find shit.
Cumberland is that shit though.
Cumberland had your size when didn't nobody have your size, niggas. Cumberland came through.
Shout out
to
Cumberland.
You ain't never really lived in the Atlanta metro area if you ain't never pulled a little cutie out of Cumberland before.
Shout out to Cumberland Mall.
Cumberland Mall has been holding niggas down
You know, that is the most, I do give you that. That is the most slept-on
mall. Most slept-on mall around this.
Because a nigga tell you to go every other mall but come.
Man,
tell you to
Cumberland
go Green
Mall, got your size.
Nigga tell you to go.
There's always some little hoes in there that want to be hollered at. You might be buying your business and get stopped. Hey, excuse me, bro. Bro, where you from? I ain't from down here. I just fuck with niggas like you. Okay, that little D-Force ass, man. Look good, like. She doing bad, though, because she live in Cobb County. So she stay with somebody.
Cobb County the best.
Know what I'm saying? Anytime you meet a cutie in Cobb County, ask them if she look good and she live in Cobb County. She stay with somebody. Big cousin, sister, or somebody.
I give you that.
Because you got to ride out there. This ain't like it's four people in an apartment. They got a big ass house, but it's a lot of people in that motherfucker. I ain't got time to break the
schematics down. No, you're right. Shout out to Cobb. I'm from Cobb.
Exactly.
Shout out to Cobb.
She had you pulling up Powder Springs Road. She stay with her auntie. Two big pretty ass bitches outside. They got a dog only white people have. Like, she got a fat ass and a border collie. Bucks with Cobb County. She's got a golden retriever.
Nigga.
They dog went to school around this bitch.
Damn.
I'm gonna start going back out there.
Shout out to Cobb.
Now, it's gonna be a lonely ass summer. I feel like everybody gonna take this summer and just be single. I feel. Because we've been in the house for a whole year.
I don't know. Niggas is already
I
out.
Don't really feel like nobody committing to nothing until at least the spring, though.
Damn.
Maybe.
Skip past spring, the
but they're not lonely. Niggas is out. Yeah. Mingling like a motherfucker.
But do you know how many people lost all they hoes during this quarantine? I'm talking about everything.
Because she got the know you and know
I'm talking
ass.
About the one who said you was never going to lose her. She gone. I'm talking about she's somebody's fiance. Even now.
How and why?
Nigga been laid up for at least 8 months.
I tell you, you never get to know somebody until you locked in on some quarantine shit.
That's what I'm saying. A lot of motherfuckers was only able to lock in with one person and lost all they hoes. I'm telling you, that was worse than a flood. I know niggas who lost 8, 9 hoes doing this shit.
It's a lot of hoes.
I'm talking about that was his hoes.
They just found out who was most important.
Quarantine wasn't nothing for you, huh?
No, it was shitty.
She was laid up with a nigga too.
It was a
don't
nigga
let
in there, for sure.
Trick you, bro.
I did quarantine with a nigga for sure.
She said her celly was 350 pounds.
She was the lookout. That was her dad.
You see what happened when you give people the information?
He got, I just know.
He shot at me with a bullet.
No, Mona, he got a delay.
Water. You can't let that out.
Shit come back to him. He had to think about it and then it looped back around in his mind. Hey, y'all remember we was talking about you going to jail? He's kind of back a little bit.
That's how we got to the titties.
That's his name, Backtrack. He gonna bring them up again. Yeah, he still want to know if I hit
Whoopi
or Queen
Latifah. No, my quarantine was full of a lot of fucking.
Neither one.
Did you quarantine alone? Nigga. Did you quarantine alone?
No.
So you had a bitch in there.
He got a whole family.
He said it like you had a wife. Man. Yeah, you grabbed that. I got a That's what marriage do to you. That's just like, dude, you had a bitch, a lot of the kids. They living, everybody live, they breathe.
That married life. What that shit hitting on, bro?
Yeah, how's that?
It ain't for the week.
Ain't shit out here in these streets, bro. If you got a good woman, you better work it out.
It ain't for the week.
24/7.
24/8. Kids is always hungry.
Yeah, they growing. They gotta
eat. Do you know how to ignore them? Have you mastered that?
Oh, yeah.
I got that shit down to a science.
Damn, master.
And if you got toddlers, you can fake sleep. That works.
But you know what's crazy? These generation babies, if you don't got Wi-Fi,
they ain't fucking with you.
Oh, man.
They ain't fucking with
you. They would literally call you broke. I'm talking about, can we go home? They broke. Their Wi-Fi ain't no good.
That shit is a crisis.
You gotta have internet.
You do.
Oh, man, wait till you move and you call your kids and be like, y'all gonna come over here? Your internet on yet? No. We'll come when the internet on. They not giving a fuck about you.
They don't play with toys no more.
Nah, bro. Game to change.
Tablets.
It's a different world.
Tablets. It's a blessing. I love it. Sit over there and don't fucking talk to me. Because I don't want to talk to you either. Love you.
How many kids you got, Mona?
I have 2 children.
You have some more?
Beautiful children. Do I want more? Yes. When I'm rich, I'll have more.
Good.
Like 3. Bang, bang, bang. Or I'll do like the rich bitches and get a bunch of them and put it in at once.
Do that.
You see these bitches having twins, that's not natural. They paying for them.
So?
You can pick the eye color, legs, how high, how tall, how short, all that.
For real?
I'm gonna pick, yes. I'm about to create me one like a creative
me
player.
Me two ball players.
Go create me a whole ass baby. Yeah. X-ray vision.
Kids bring joy to your life. It's like the worst and best thing I've ever did.
They do.
Like you love them. But like I feel like if you don't think here and there like, damn, I could have go ahead and gave her that 350. You don't really love them children. You know
I
what
love
mean?
Shit out of my
real parents son. Think about if they wasn't around.
Yeah, I'm probably gonna have me some more too.
You want more?
Hell yeah. I might get me some more and some stepkids.
You planning on having
stepkids? Yeah, I just want to be an old nigga with a room full of kids and people like, look at y'all. I raised all y'all.
How many kids do you have now?
One. I feel like I should have had more when I was younger.
You don't have one.
I should have been out here yes. with six and
that's
seven.
That's wrong. Like, that's wrong. I'm the only child.
All Burberry shirts on. I miss that good. Shit. I should have been getting these hoes pregnant, bro. If I would have known I was going to be straight later on,
thanks.
Oh, I would have. Ooh.
Damn, that's a fact.
Because I know I missed two good baby mamas.
Man, that's a fact. Because
I be seeing what they be posting on Facebook now. I be like, oh, I should have got her. I'm talking about, all I did was, on her. Should have put it in her. Damn.
Damn, that's a fact, Los. You gotta have more than one. Only children are weird. Kids need siblings. You gotta have somebody you conspire. Like, I wish we
could
kill mama.
I know.
You gotta have that person to grow up.
I know, but I fucked around and
I did the same
but them
shit.
Only, but them only child kids, they love bragging they
no
was
kids.
Only child.
I did what he did all my life. I've been spraying on him.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, exactly. If my baby mama had been probably a little bit nicer, I probably would have got another one. But she made me not want another one.
That happens.
If she would have just been a little bit, I probably would have ended up with two. But I'm so glad I did. I be looking at niggas with two baby mamas like, how, nigga?
Oh, yeah, facts.
How do you do this facts. Shit? You got two people that hate you.
Facts. Damn, I wish I would have had more kids when I was young. You right.
I should have had some more.
How many you got?
I got two.
Two. At least you got two.
I should have had some more.
Damn, I should have had about
five.
Woo! Because we be straight by now.
No.
It still work, right? Yeah.
It's different now. When you older, don't nobody want to watch your kids?
Nah.
When you young, man, everybody watch your kids.
Don't nobody watch my fucking kids now. Them kids in the trunk. They all stay all back.
Yeah, we should have.
I'm going to miss my opportunity.
Should have had some more.
They watching.
It's downhill now.
It is. Now I'm just at the point like, whatever.
Have some more.
I should.
You have to. Only children are fucking weird. I would be so quiet. It would be so boring. I would have like imaginary class. So I'm in there talking to like 20 kids. And then I would have imaginary student teacher. I had to cuss that bitch out because she could never get the kids to relax.
Wait, this some shit you did because you was the only child?
What else I'm going to do?
Imaginary shit.
Wow. Play with.
Damn.
It was bad.
That's where you went wrong at. And making up shit.
You got it. You got to have more than one. Kids need somebody to like bond with.
Should have had me some more kids.
Damn, you still got
I
would have
had about three.
Y'all pullout game is immaculate. If you really pulling out and not getting nobody pregnant on pre-cum.
For real?
So that means you know when you pre-coming, because you get pregnant on pre-cum.
Oh, yeah. Hell, yeah. You got to pre-pull out, too.
Yeah, you got to jerk it, pull out and jerk it.
Nah, yeah, pull it out and wipe it off, start over.
Who been pregnant off a pre-cum?
I got pregnant off pre-cum.
Yeah.
You did?
She's not sure of that.
Right. I'm sure of it. You know I'm sure of it? Because I don't like cum.
What?
I don't like to be caming.
Oh, my.
But you can't control that.
Yes, you can't pull it the fuck out.
You can.
I can ask for it.
Mm-mm.
Like, it's not like I'm just meeting a nigga. He know what I don't like. So he's going to pull out.
So how you know I'm pre-cum?
Because he pulled out.
What's the fucking math? Where's the math? What are we missing here?
I don't even know why
she
you walked yourself in.
She didn't get nutted up in. Her club didn't get shot up is what she's trying to say.
No, the club didn't get shot out, but it was a shooting in the parking lot.
Yes, exactly. That's how I got pregnant.
It was a stabbing in the booth.
Right?
Yeah. That's exactly how I got
pregnant. The fight started in the club.
Yeah, it was in the club for sure. It was in the booth.
Niggas act like they're so disgusted when they get somebody pregnant. That's what happens when you come in somebody to get pregnant. I don't know why men do that. Like, I feel like y'all know how somebody can really, like, manipulate and, like, try to ruin your life for so long. So I would be real, like, careful with my cum. Because if we, me and you meet, we having sex, right? And we don't have that type of relationship, and now I'm pregnant, and you say, yo, I really don't want it. To me, a woman should take that info in, but they don't. Like, a woman knows she wants the baby from the gate. Yeah. She don't give a fuck about how you feel.
I learned that. That's why you gotta find a woman who don't want it too.
I just think it's unfair. Y'all need that pill. Y'all need that birth control pill. Y'all need something to be able to protect y'all.
Nah, we're straight. Y'all really think we out here trying to live better? We like
to go raw.
No, we don't need no birth control, nigga. That's gonna take the fun out of it.
I think everybody
likes that. That take the thrill out of it. You're like, well, she's not pregnant, so fuck. Take this fucking birth control pill and go out here and continue to not get anybody pregnant.
If there was a pill that you could take, you wouldn't take it?
No.
Really?
No, because I don't talk shit. Anyway. When I'm in the pussy, I'm like, yeah, this that non-birth control thing.
No drugs.
Like that shit, don't you? They don't even make dick like this no more. No GMOs, no birth control.
I got a file.
Put my hand behind my head.
Little remedies and shit?
Nah.
Keep it to yourself.
Organic dick.
That nigga said no GMOs.
I tell certain people.
No preservatives.
I'll let you know.
Thanks. We had a light skin meeting.
That's cool.
You niggas
still ain't taking no birth control, Mona. Fuck y'all.
I mean, if it was out with my sons of age, I would get it for them. I would put them on and all that.
I mean,
I have a lot of male friends. I've seen women do things like that. They don't even want the baby. They just want what he got or want the situation. A bitch will try to force you into that.
Ha-ha, plot twist. I ain't got shit. Got tricked out your pussy. Thought you had a good baby daddy.
Thought you had one, bitch.
Nah, man. We just
plot
talking shit.
Twist. I think it's unfair, though.
That nigga been sitting there thinking about them kids he should have had ever since I said that shit.
Oh, yeah, bro.
Your wife gonna watch this shit and punch the fuck out of you.
Who the fuck was you thinking about when you gazed in the air like that?
Exactly. You done fucked up now.
Yeah, you in trouble. When she zooming on this gaze, you gonna get your ass whooped.
Yeah.
Blink twice if you're in trouble.
Damn.
Brilliant. She hit you, blink twice.
It's all good. We bring some more kids to the fold, bro. That's what we're doing. It's the summer.
Fuck it, let's make some kids.
Yeah, I'm gonna find me two-step kids.
Y'all can make kids to keep moving. No, I
want two more where I'm just fucking their mama. They daddy ain't never coming back or some shit. Just gonna be fucking their mama off and on 15, 20 years or something.
Facts.
Help her raise
them
kids.
Stepdads are cool. Shout out to the stepdads, man.
They are. I'm like, who your mama hood? My mama ain't got no hood. She been messing with the same man 20 years.
That nigga cool as hell.
Uncle Rose. Cool as fuck.
Uncle
Daddy.
Yeah. There's a lot of good women out here working too hard.
I had a couple stepdaddies in my life.
A couple?
Mm-hmm. Shout out to mine.
I had the same one forever. I'm glad. I'm glad I ain't have to go through that. I had the same one.
I had a couple,
man. Nothing wrong with it.
Yeah, my daddy was around.
You had a dad? Wow.
I had a dad.
Should we clap
that? That's why you were so successful, bro.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Think you begging me because you got a dad, nigga?
Yeah.
No, my dad was awesome.
Nah,
I am better than you a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, come on.
You can't make a deep dish pizza, though.
I can't. Not a prison joint.
Yeah, that's what she better than you, bro.
Yeah.
I ain't even get to the top layer yet.
I want you to make
it
one
in the microwave.
That's all we have. Microwave and 190 water. That's the hot water on a unit. If you go down this Philly water, you burn that bitch with it.
Mona, when you coming back to the A?
I'm going to come back next week.
Come back, and then I want one of them deep dish joints.
All right.
Straight pepperoni, though. I don't need all that extra shit, because we got ingredients now.
No pork, though.
Huh?
I don't eat pork.
You don't have to eat it. It's mine.
I'm not making you pork. I'm giving you beef pepperoni. Have you had it? It's
no,
amazing.
I don't want that shit.
You want pork.
If you had pizza in Philadelphia, you had beef pepperoni.
But check this out, though. You trying to... Fuck it. Never mind. You sit probably on YouTube at this point. I don't fucking need you is all I'm saying. I wanted you to be included, but once you took that little fucked up attitude...
I'm going to make the pizza for you.
I mean, don't tell me what you're not going to put on my shit, though, Mona.
I'm
going
to put on the pizza, but I want you to taste how I taste it.
I asked about all that. You already sold me on the idea of the bitch being good. I'm like, ooh, I wonder what the kind of pizza I like it tastes like. Right. I don't like all this shit you name. I know the ingredients I want on my deep dish. I've been to Chicago.
God, that Philadelphia is a Muslim city.
Yeah, it's a lot of Muslims. I'm Muslim.
Ain't no pork.
Don't just pick and choose when to be Muslim. You wasn't Muslim when you was in jail and shit.
Yes, I was.
You was following the law then.
I mean, clearly, like, you can see a Muslim that's practicing because they wear overgarment. But I'm Muslim by faith.
Your whole legs is out. You going to hell.
I went to Juma Friday. I didn't
got
know
nails,
you
nails, tattoos,
yes.
Smoking blunts.
And children.
And out of wedlock. Kids.
Out of wedlock, yeah.
What?
You know you can't touch the women on Juma?
She hugged me when I walked in here. They was stoning the shit out of her.
Yes. I didn't know that.
But you can't do what?
Stoned. But you can't hug the women. Or you can't, you know what
I'm
saying?
Bro, you know the crazy
sister,
shit, though?
When I went
over there to Dubai, they still be trying to flirt. They be looking at a nigga. They be like,
you're not supposed to make eye contact like that.
They be, man, they be doing, they hit a nigga with them eyes.
You went to Dubai?
Hell
Dubai.
Yeah, scary as a motherfucker.
Was it?
Because you see how we just normal, and then you see somebody show up, and them motherfucker got a tent on. You like, it kind of catch you off guard.
Could you smoke weed there?
No.
It was like no weed, no drinking, no nothing.
You can't do
shit. You
got to
abide by some strict rules.
They got some niggas over there that's so black, they look like they blue.
They probably beautiful.
But if you call them black, they be like, no, you
ew,
black.
Ew, yup, black. Yeah, you black, not me. Yeah.
Nigga, look, I'm talking about this nigga would look like he was frozen or some shit, like a purplish blue. With some black ass hair.
Colorism goes in every difference, not just black people.
I don't
like
give
that
a
dark
fuck.
Light shit.
Some of them niggas was so excited to see me though. I was like, I don't know where the fuck y'all was. I can pull up at the gas station, they got these dudes who just pump the gas. I guess a lot of shit over there that's real baller. That's for regular ass people. They got gas pumpers in them. I got out the car and it's like, Karlous, wildin' out, Saw brother!
They pump your gas in New Jersey too.
I don't know.
By law.
They pump your gas in New Jersey.
I ain't never had to buy gas in New Jersey.
You never been to Atlantic City?
We always
Yeah, I do.
New
I got
Jersey.
A show coming up there. I'm just come in and do my show and shit. Yeah.
Well, you doing better than me, nigga. I ain't never been to Dubai.
What you mean?
Me neither.
I ain't never been to Dubai.
How is that doing better than you?
Cause you been to Dubai.
That
you went over Eddie Murphy house.
You went over Eddie Murphy house?
Tell us about Eddie house.
This nigga said Eddie Murphy live in a castle, bro. Did you tell Eddie Murphy about me, bro?
That's how niggas are.
I did.
You did?
Yeah.
My nigga.
Come on, man.
My nigga. As long as you did. Cause my nigga, cause Nav didn't.
Huh?
Nav did the whole movie with him. You didn't even tell Eddie Murphy
that's
that.
Fucked up.
It's 10 niggas waiting for me to tell him
but
about
you. You know me too long. I ain't never been a hater.
Word.
Shut I spread up, love.
Man. Word.
Can we hear about the house?
I can't look. Eddie's a known boxing fan, and he had these big boxing viewing parties at his crib. There's no way to explain that shit. It's literally like in the beginning of Coming to America, when King Joffe Joffre is walking him through, and his zebras and shit walking. You know what I mean? They walking out, and that's his house.
Damn.
He still lived there, and that motherfucking Zamunda.
Zamunda so the first house is his house.
The Zamunda Castle. Remember in the beginning of the movie, Paramount, you see the Paramount logo, and then you see that big ass fucking castle in the middle of the forest. That's his house.
Oh. I didn't know that.
LA.
My son what? What is he now?
I've been waiting all day.
Believe me, I've tied my own shoes once. It is an overrated experience. Let them wait. I'm talking to my son.
Love that fucking movie. Legendary.
What'd you think about the second one?
I think that you can't follow a classic like that.
I agree.
It's just leave it alone.
You cannot sequel everything.
But again, Eddie always gonna be the GOAT. I got a painting of that nigga on my wall, so I'm always pay homage.
Is that your favorite comedian?
Yeah.
Who's your favorite comedian?
Karlous Miller.
Who's your favorite comedian?
Prior
to, but I like Alive, you know.
Alive?
Yeah.
Earthquake.
David Chappelle for me. It was prior Paul Mooney, but they're gone. I'm a huge Paul Mooney fan. Like, I have a goal of making niggas walk out like he did.
Paul Mooney is fine.
I watch like Kobe Bryant a lot. I'm my own fan.
That's hard. Right.
I'm the GOAT.
That's hard.
I'm in Mamba mindset. If you don't believe me, let's book the show and you prove it to me. You got to beat me.
Quit touching shit.
Fuck that.
Quit touching shit.
Go get whoever.
That's how you supposed to think.
Whoever you want to get.
That's that rapper shit.
When I get to heaven, I'm going to follow some of them niggas.
That's that rapper shit.
I'm the truth too, nigga.
You're funny.
Yeah, I was up at Jesus' last weekend. Yeah, nigga, I got a standing O2, nigga. Yeah.
That's hard, bro.
Yeah, I'll be doing this shit in the next life too.
Who's your second favorite comedian?
One of these niggas. You know, one of them. Whoever. Whoever.
Karlous don't give a fuck.
Damn sure don't. Fuck around and say the wrong name. What is, whatever. A lot of them niggas don't like me no more, so.
You done made it.
Fuck around and show love to the wrong motherfuckers. I don't fuck with them either.
I fucks with you because you're an island. You don't mind being on that island, and you don't give a fuck who swim up to it or who leave it. You gonna always be that island, and that's what you content with that.
Exactly.
And as long as you content, you gonna always have peace.
Peaceful as a motherfucker.
Because you don't need no other island to come join your island. You good.
Good. That's exactly how I like it. This game solitude, will break your heart solitude. If you believe this shit, man.
Facts.
Yeah, for sure.
Don't let them take your motherfucking heart.
Mm-mm. That's why you see niggas out here going crazy right now, because they be thinking that, hey, this the one. And then when that one ain't the one, they don't have no backup plan. Mm.
Especially when you're not like, I mean, people, you know, people, some people are really trying really hard. It was, like I said earlier, it was comedy college at Warm Daddy's in Philadelphia. You could pay $500 to learn. To me, you can't learn how to be funny. It's like,
that's no more matter, of preparation, though.
I mean, or maybe timing or whatever, but some of these
can somebody
people
check just, on the chicken, please?
Some of these people is just unnatural. It's just, you don't have a funny bone in your body. It's something, it's just not it for you. But for me, I feel like when you funny, well, for me, like me making somebody laugh, making myself laugh, like that shit make me feel better. Like that's how I've gotten through shit my whole life. So whether I'm under a bridge, homeless, or I'm in a fucking mansion, I'm gonna be laughing and making somebody next to me.
Do you have a herringbone on your sock?
Yes, yeah. I do. And look at the chain matches. It's black on.
She a queen of the hood, bro. Yeah. She making up for that time she's spending the hole.
This shit came out of a time machine from 1992.
Damn, you like it?
She used to date like a drug dealer nigga, and he gave her that.
I'm not mad at it. I'm actually not mad at it.
Chain was bigger, and it broke, so she made a chain.
She made a link. A linklet?
Remember they used to pop chains and snatch earrings and shit?
You used to do that shit?
No, I said remember when they did. In the early 90s, that was a thing. People would snatch your pocketbook, you don't remember?
I try to stay away from that life.
You freak your black and miles?
And snatch, I don't champ them, no. I just smoke them.
You just smoke your black and
no. My brother here, he champ shit. I don't do that.
What?
I just smoke them. What's
I
up?
Think that's a, ain't that like the sin?
Why are you judging
supposed,
me?
You supposed to freak the black and miles, I thought. It make it pull better.
I don't think you know shit about black and miles. You got flat shoes on, bro. Your shoes is too flat. You not even about that life.
Yeah, niggas that wear beans.
You got no socks on.
Niggas that wear beans smoke raw paper.
They ain't got no socks on. That nigga is happy in life. He gave up.
Go with a kale smoothie.
You just be out here with this nigga with no socks on, bro.
I'll let that like nigga it. Do what the fuck he
these
do.
These Vans, bro, you don't post to always
he done wrote on his shoes,
shirt,
man.
Vans, it goes together.
You feel me?
Aesthetic. Yeah. You got you like a always cool bumper sticker.
I'll let him wear shoes with no arches, nigga. He don't give a fuck.
Generally, he any sneak that you can fold in half is enough for me.
He a flat-footed beast, and I don't get in his motherfucking way. Let him do what the fuck he do.
He want to ball that motherfucker in the ball. He cold. I think the nigga gotta be recognized as a cold nigga, though. Keep doing your thing, Brandon Lewis.
Thank you, dog.
Don't never let this be the last time you come to the trap.
Yes, sir.
Where can they find you at?
He from the A.
You can find me on Instagram, who is Brandon Lewis. New season of Roast Me. I host Roast Me on All Def Digital. New season, I came to Atlanta, I got all my dogs.
You ain't get me. So now I know I ain't your dog. Now I know I ain't your dog.
You are my dog, but you ain't overlooked.
I could have did something. I could have came down there and said, you know, this is my dog shit, just coming down here to show love to Brent. But fuck it, go ahead, tell me.
But I got set it off.
No, don't worry about it.
But I got set it off.
But that look, that's going, all right, go ahead.
Thank you. Shout out to set it off, man. I got set it off.
You gotta give these niggas a hard time, bro. No matter where you at in life.
I know your rhythm.
I don't give can a fuck. I know your rhythm.
Yes. Please tell them where your OnlyFans
okay,
is.
Okay, well, don't call me white girl. I don't have OnlyFans. You could just DM me and I'll send you a picture of this pussy through the Cash App.
How much you want to push this pussy?
Ask me in the DM for a question. I feel a lot of judgment coming
you
off.
Ain't no, no, follow you. No, that was no judgment.
You ain't even got no fucking socks
no.
on. I'm trying
shout
to be polite
man,
with you.
Bro. You don't supposed to wear socks all the time.
Up
man.
North, if you could ball your
she
fucking sticks in a
pussy,
ball,
y'all.
That's a no for us. But I ain't judging you about it. I like it. I like the aesthetic. So stop fucking judging me. I've been in jail, smoke blacks. Anyway, I got a show in Baltimore, July 31st, okay?
Jasmine Sullivan's album. I'm on here talking about my daddy issues. Terrible. You should go check it out.
I love Jasmine Sullivan.
She's the best. She's gorgeous. She can sing. She's amazing. Vegan.
Wait, she was on the new album?
I'm on the new album, Hotel.
Hotels, damn.
Yes. I have a hotel. I'll check me out. Don't call me white girl. Don't forget. And I have something really big coming out that I can't talk about. But it's really a show.
Okay.
All right? This is lit for me. You know what I mean? I'm trying to get these kids out together.
I'm not mad at you.
Listen, you can't be. It's out there to snatch purses. You know what I'm saying?
What's next?
I'm producing shit right now.
Bro, you done did
TV
it all.
Shows.
You had Joe's show.
Yeah.
A bunch of other shit.
What else do you do, really?
I do everything. I'm of the mindset of no limitations.
Let's create something. We got 85 South Media. We got our own media company. We got our own record company. We got our own studio. We getting ready to take the Tyler Perry rapper.
Y'all are the blueprint to what a lot of niggas need to be paying attention to.
You niggas ours?
Yeah.
No, I'm serious though. Like, y'all are the blueprint of taking an opportunity and making a business out of it, making an enterprise, a multi-faceted, multi-branched business out of it. It's fucking brilliant.
Bro, that's why we've been trying to tell these motherfuckers. I think they scared to fuck with us.
Who?
All these people, bro. We legit over here.
All what people?
Nigga, we'll rap off camera. I don't like to say shit on
but
here.
But no, because
they steal so much point, content from this show.
Without you saying any names, fuck them people. Y'all making your own bread on your own. People gonna steal anyway, but this is how I look at that, right? People have been stealing my YouTube videos, they steal my IG lives, and they put them on all kind of pages, and they get their revenue shares. I look at that shit as, okay, we in the 90s, and y'all niggas is my street team. So I ain't had to go pay y'all niggas directly. Go get your little rev share off of that video. But now y'all are promoting my name as if my face was on the side of a van or a car.
But I mean, that part I'm okay with. I would just, a clip of me talking on a podcast a year ago just went viral.
No, they'll take the whole shit.
Oh, wait. That's what I want to know. How do you feel about a motherfucker taking your bit and just saying it out their mouth? You know what I mean?
Like, I've had niggas actual take actual jokes.
I've had niggas take the pep ready to dick ready. That's, whole shit. Whole minute of saying.
You got to run up on people like that.
That's what I feel like.
You have to have that conversation. If someone's taking your material, I'm talking about something different.
That's why I'm trying to sue the internet.
The media.
Seriously, though. I feel what you're saying.
You got to get like these record companies. These motherfuckers got so much fingerprints in their music that.
And that's what I'm. That's what I'm talking about. Them
you
people.
You
want
to ID your shit? I get it.
Yeah. Mm. Those well, people who next. Show up with
but
the fucking paper hanging out the briefcase.
We're
gonna sue the shit out of these
you
motherfuckers.
You see somebody doing a Karlous Miller bit? It's all in the comments. You stole this from Karlous. The people see.
Good.
They talk about
good.
It. You know what I mean?
I appreciate them people. Like that.
Appreciate
y'all. Y'all stop stealing from
Karlous
Miller. All I'm saying is there are a lot of people out here with great material. Steal some of that. You have to use all of mine. I'm gonna be up in this bitch doing sign language. Like, Los, what the fuck happened?
And it's still gonna be funnier. That's the thing.
They got it now. Stole everything. Took everything. I ain't got nothing left. Stole my voice. They stole my acting.
Now you
going
to have a death association on your ass.
My jokes in. Caving, you and my...
Yeah, they coming
it's going to be 50 deaf niggas in this nigga DM.
Yo, that was fucked up. Are you saying?
And they got to send you videos so you can really feel them.
It's going to be a silent protest. Yeah. This nigga
oh, my here. God. The quietest protest ever is going to be 100 deaf protest. Niggas yeah, they, silently marching.
You know what they're really going to do? The sign language. The people. Fake sign language.
Yeah, we love
really
the deaf people. We love y'all.
They didn't hear you.
A, B, C.
Y'all, they love a joke, too. Y'all can take a joke.
They didn't.
I know the alphabet.
They ain't gonna hear this shit until the captions come out. Oh, rim, rim, rim.
Oh, my God.
Rim, rim.
Oh, God, yeah.
All right.
I'll keep you impersonating. Who's your favorite person?
I don't have one.
Really?
No.
See? Fuck them people. That's what I've been saying.
No, it's not even about, for me, it's just, impressions are one of my tools to get the job done. You know what I mean? I'm not an impressionist. I'm just a nigga who got a couple talents and I use every talent that makes money to pay these fucking bills.
What's the fan favorite people ask for the most?
Oh, Jay-Z.
Yeah, I'm about to say it's Hov for me.
They always ask Jay-Z, but recently they started asking more from Maya
Denzel,
Angelou.
You do Denzel too?
No, I don't do Denzel. I do a version, but no, that's Jay-Z.
Chris Rock.
Chris Rock.
Russell Simmons.
Yeah, Russell.
Yeah, Chris
Russell.
Rock, yeah.
But no, Maya Angelou, Maya got bars. Y'all niggas on, y'all, she one of the original MCs. I'm here to tell you all, listen. Shorty, I'm there for you anytime you need me. For real, girl, it's me in your world. Believe me.
The world is it. The world is Neil. It's the world.
The world is yours. It's mine, it's mine, it's mine.
It's crazy.
Whose world is this?
I would think she was
yours, Karlous Miller.
That's crazy.
Karlous Miller, look at me when I'm talking to you.
I can't.
The world is yours.
Stop, man.
You're an island. You're like Aruba. With blue waters floating all around your sand. But inside of that island, you're still a nigga. Still a solid nigga. And I salute thee, and still I rise, like a phoenix out of the ashes.
Hey, man, this has been another episode of 85 South, so we out this bitch. That shit is crazy. Get a photo, man.
My guy.
What time is it?
I got a piss.
We gotta take a picture.
Let's do it.
Sit back down.
You sit. He ain't even say please, that nigga.
Sit back down, please.
Come on over here, titties. Why you keep scooting over here? Put closer like we know each other.